25 of 44 for just 213.
And think about the character of this Oiler team and the close games that they have won this year. That's a tribute to Jeff Fisher.
Dolphins at their until they won in Oakland last year. Miami was 0 for 9 in Oakland. John Gruden's Raiders, oh my goodness. Donald Hollis pass to Ricky Dudley, picked off by Sam Madison, who dollies it for Jimmy Johnson. Dolphins get a field goal. Robert Jones, a sack on Donald Hollis at the one. Watch the next play. Hollis. Are you kidding me? It's a half a yard reception, interception return for a touchdown by Zach Thomas. 10-0 Dolphins. Rodney Williams gets the kick. Takes the lick. Coughs up the pig. And what a nice play by the Dolphins to fall on the football. Dolphins capitalize. Dan Marino to Ronde Gadsden. Now does Gadsden get it? Watch him switch the hands here. And it's inside the pole.
Yeah, we didn't see a lot of great calls by the officials. This was one. He does a great job of getting that ball around the pylon before he hits the ground. The good call was touchdown.
17-0. Donald Hollis, you know, has done well. He's 4-1 as a starter. Oh, but not today. There's the overthrow. Then Sam Madison. Defensive back blitz. Sacks Hollis. It's a Raider field goal. Next possession. You saw this once already. Can it happen again? Hollis for Harvey Williams. Oh, no! It's picked off by Robert Jones. Two interceptions, traveling a total of 9 yards. 14 points for the Dolphins. All their points off Oakland turnovers. Hollis sacked 8 times. Threw 6 interceptions in the game. Wade Wilson came in. Remember the Raiders were 8-2 a few years ago and finished 8-8? They were what? 7-3? They're now 7-6. And a critical win for the Miami Dolphins, because next week on ESPN, they host the fellow 9-4 New York football Jets. Oh, but we saved the best for last. The Chiefs try to make the Broncos bid for history go by the boards. TD and the Broncos had the answer.
As you get closer, your eyes get wider. Your heart beats faster. Your determination grows strong. This is not going to beat you. Oh, it's loud. And it's dirty. And yeah, it's big. But so are your plans. Hey, John boy, you ain't Kansas anymore. From here on in, every day's going to be a test. Those who pass deserve a great beer. Sam Adams. It's what's inside.
Hunting for a great deal on a great ATV? Then hurry to your Yamaha dealer for all-terrain value days. And get zero down and payments as low as $69 a month for 3 full years on not one, not two, but 9 great Yamaha models. So quit messing around. And hurry to your Yamaha dealer today for all-terrain value days. Because at this rate, they won't last long.
People, today's agenda, the information age.
What happened to the industrial age?
That was last century.
Those were the days. You built it, you sold it.
No more living in the past. Today, it's not just what you make, it's what you know that matters.
He always gets so proactive around the millennials.
All I know is they need help communicating down there.
Look, he just quit, and years of knowledge are going out the door with him.
Isn't there a way to capture what he knows?
Over there. She's got thousands of documents on the network.
Finding the one she needs should be simpler.
He's got half a good idea over there. She's got the other half.
We get the picture.
What are we supposed to do about it?
Make it simpler for people to exchange ideas.
Share documents. Have conversations.
Right, so they create knowledge they can use.
They'll need it.
With new software,
new hardware.
Relax, I've got us a partner down there.
But they only make...
Not anymore, they don't.
Oh.
Keep the conversation going. Share the knowledge. The Digital Document Company, Xerox.
Randall Cunningham. What a storybook season he has had. Vikings host the Bears at 8:15, about 8 minutes from now. The Denver Broncos, a few weeks ago, dispatched of the Kansas City Chiefs on Monday night, 30-7. For the game, Gunther Cunningham, John Elway, changing pleasantries because Elway knew the Chiefs would be coming. All-out blitz, Anthony Davis falls on Elway. Could the Broncos keep the dream alive? They went into the game 12-0. Chiefs defense forces a punt. 3 and out on the second possession. Tom Ruin can't handle the ball. Greg Minuski gets it, and the turnover gives the Chiefs the ball. Next play, Rich Gannon. Play action. Pretty pass to Andre. Bad moon rising. 7-0 Kansas City at Mile High Stadium. Rising does the salute. Play action all day for Kansas City.
Well, and play action on first down. This is 18 yards to Andre Rison. Does a great job of getting down low for the football. And then again, the first down play action pass. Gannon looking deep and Darian Gordon getting called against Alexander for the interference right at about the 1 yard line.
He should end up scoring. It's 21-7. Now it's 21-14. Terrell Davis outside 17 yards. Jerome Woods looks like a late hit. Is a late hit. 15 yards. Broncos get the ball to 13. Already, though, Kansas City scoring touchdown. Denver knows we better put the throttle on the offense. Elway to E.C. Ed McCaffrey. We're tied at 21, 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. What a good game. Third quarter, Broncos driving. Elway. Ron Smith makes the grab. He had a career-high 165 yards receiving. Second and goal on the drive. Davis, right, slips. Fumble at the one. Chiefs recover. First fumble for TD in 836 touches. I mean, that's not even real. Third and 10, late third quarter, Kansas City, Gannon. Joe Little Bighorn, first career touchdown. Chiefs lead at 28-21. No field goals here. Chiefs get a field goal, make it 31-21. Elway, Willie Green, Dale Carter doesn't tackle. Willie Green, color up, money, breaks free, down to the one. When you get the ball to the one, guess what? Terrell Davis is going to score a touchdown. His third of the day. 21 for his career. 31-28. Elway. 3:39 to go. Touchdown. Shannon Sharp. First reception of the day. Touchdown. Broncos lead. First time. 35-31. Chiefs one last chance. First down. Gannon. Incomplete to Rison. Second down. Gannon. Pass tipped by former Chief Neil Smith. Third down. Gannon. Overthrows Tony Gonzalez. Fourth and 10. Last gap. Gannon. Sacked by Alfred Williams. Marty Schottenheimer's team was so game. But the Denver Broncos, in really a grudge match, beat the Chiefs 35-31. They are now 13-0. They have won 18 straight overall, tying the NFL record set by a Bears team in the 30s, Bears team in the 40s, 72-73 Dolphins, 88-89 Niners. And they knew they'd be in for a test.
Well, and I think that's the thing. Much of what they will have to do during the course of this season will be character. Every team will approach them as this is the opportunity to make our season. That's what you've seen from San Diego and the Chiefs the last 2 weeks.
They knew Kansas City would bring it physically. They weren't sure they would have to score as many touchdowns.
That's right.
But when you have Terrell Davis, who's 21 now with the record of 25, you got the man for the job. What an effort by both teams. Jake the Snake Plumber. Cardinals stinking wild card with the Giants stinking sneakers.
EA Sports presents Tiger versus Cyber Tiger.
Hey, Tiger. You ever think about caddying?
Don't make me come over there.
Step aside. It's combo time.
Combo?
Check it out. Get him.
Oh, that combo.
Tiger Woods, 99. PGA Tour Golf. Be him or beat him. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Unobtainable for most. A dream for all. Who will win it this year? All next week on ESPN Classic. A look back at the Heisman Trophy and the greatest college football players of all time. Old school stars who proved that dreams really do come true. Heisman Week. All next week. Only on ESPN Classic. To get ESPN Classic, call 1-800-CLASSIC today.
Here's us bears. It must be ma chérie.
Remember, today is MCI 5 cents Sunday. The day you can jingle these bells for just 5 cents a minute.
It's MCI 5 cents Sunday.
If you're not an MCI customer, call 1-800-Sundays.
Cardinals' last playoff berth before Arizona became a state. They are at home against the New York Football Giants. They're 0-3 against their old friend Jim Fossil on a shovel pass. Jake Plummer, Adrian Morrell, 20 yards. Cards, you figure they're going to win at a laugher. They lead the Giants 7-0. But the Giants do have some defense, Tom.
Yeah, Cedric Jones here, a great job of getting around the corner, then forcing the fumble and then recovering it. A double play for Jones.
Giants trail 17-13 off a turnover. Charles, get out of my way. 8 yards. Giants have run for 341 yards in the two games this year against Arizona. Giants lead it 20-17. Late fourth quarter, Cards down 6. Plummer, scrambling. He's one of the best at this. 29-yard run. Down to the 21-yard line, but a Cardinal penalty. He's like the old Cards. Chad Bratsky. Sacks Plummer makes him a Brockwurst. But Sean Williams called for a penalty. So the drive still goes. 4th-3 from the 6. Plummer. Pass. Knocked down by Corey Widmer, intended for Frank Sanders. And the Giants pull the upset in Arizona, beating the Cardinals 23-19, despite the fact the Kent Graham throwing was just 8 of 23 for buck 44. Gary Brown, 124, way 60. 6-7 right now is the wild card bird.
Primetime Players is brought to you by MCI WorldCom. Log on to ESPN.com to vote for your primetime player.
You know what? I'm going to give it to Chad Eaton. 300-pound man in the middle with 3 sacks, 8 tackles, forced fumble, as the Patriots defense did it to the Steelers.
And mine goes to the Saints defense, which held Dallas to 8 yards. You do the math. We've been trying to do it here. It's about a foot and a half per carry.
Less than a foot and a half a carry. Some decisions to make, and the Broncos' run at history is still alive. Ooh, is this exciting. For Tom Jackson, I'm Chris Berman. Thanks for watching NFL Primetime. Mike and the gang, Bears at the Vikings. Enjoy.
Thanks, Chris, and welcome to the Metrodome, home of the NFL's hottest attraction. Rookie sensation Randy Moss and the 11-1 Vikings host the Bears on ESPN Sunday Night Football.
Give me what you got on 3. 1, 2, 3. Give me what you got.
You got game?
Well, anytime I think about the game of football, I think about having fun.
I just wish everybody could experience what it's like to be in the locker room.
We got to make sure that we play better across the board, one play at a time.
We just beat everybody we played. I mean, that's not our fault.
Mike's got game.
Yes, I am you, not me. Me,
never thought that I'd play this game again and didn't have any desire.
I think he is a better player now, but I think he's a smarter player.
I mean, I'm just a rookie.
Randy's got game.
Just try to look at everything people say as motivation to go out there and just destroy somebody's team.
That feels good.
We have team goals, and that's all that really matters.
To be in the big show at the end of the year, that's what it all comes down to. I don't know how you could accept anything less than a Super Bowl.
Mike's got game.
We got game.
On ESPN. Let's launch this thing now.
Minneapolis, Minnesota, where the entire city is caught up in Viking mania, and it gets no hotter nor louder than inside the Metrodome, where a sellout crowd is ready for their NFC rivals, the Bears. Hello, everybody. Mike Patrick along with Joe Theismann and Paul McGuire. It's great to have you with us. Back in September, the Bears gave the Vikings all they can handle. In fact, they led 21-10 at the half before losing at 31-28. But that was with a huge day from Eric Kramer. He's out for the season now. So, Joe, how do they do it again?
Well, Mike, I really think the Bears on offense have to take the same approach. They have to run the football. They have to work their play-action game to try and get some opportunities down the field. But Dave Wannstedt has done one other thing. He has put the onus on his offensive line and said, we want to keep the crowd out of this as much as possible. You've got to not take any sacks.
With the win tonight, the Minnesota Vikings would go to 12-1 and end the Packers' reign as three-year divisional champs. They have done it with a big play arsenal second to none. And, Paul, when you talk about big plays, the name that comes to mind is Randy Moss.
Yeah, and there are receivers in the National Football League that have his size and his speed and his jumping ability, but I have never seen anyone that has all three like Randy Moss has. Now, the Chicago Bears tonight are going to challenge this guy. And what I mean by that is they're going to put two people on him. They're going to see how tough he really is. They're going to bump him and be physical with him at the line of scrimmage, and then they're going to have a safety come over the top. They're going to try to take away the deep threat.
All right, Paul, and no question, Randall Cunningham will be looking his way. It's the Minnesota Vikings and the Chicago Bears on ESPN Sunday Night Football.
Welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Welcome back to the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Let's go to the sidelines. Solomon Wilcots and Vikings head coach Dennis Green.
Thanks, Mike. Coach Green, without the speed of Robert Smith in the backfield tonight, how would that change things on offense for you?
I think the big thing, we have to be very consistent. We might have to have some 12, 13, 14-yard drives for scores. I think that's going to be great for our offense. Real consistent, real sharp, and really execute.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Be back.
And, Mike, the Vikings have already clinched their sixth playoff appearance over the last 7 years. A win tonight will give Denny Green his third division title and a first-round bye in the playoffs.
All right, Solomon, thanks very much. Dave Wannstedt not concerned with the division title, of course, just survival at 39-53 through six seasons with the Chicago Bears. He likes his team a lot better than he has the last couple, but it hasn't translated yet into wins. Jeff Jaeger will kick it off with one touchback this year. Mo Williams and David Palmer, Palmer number 22, back to receive. He is fifth in the NFC in kickoff returns, 22-7 a crack. Sellout crowd of 64,152 on hand here at the Metrodome tonight. They have loved every minute of this season. And we're set to go from Minneapolis. Palmer from the four. Up to the 24-yard line. The Vikings offense has Randall Cunningham at quarterback. This is the finest season of his career. 23 touchdowns, 7 interceptions, the top rating in the NFL. Horde starts at running back for the injured Robert Smith. Carter working on 1,000 yards again. Moss already has his. A superb line with Pro Bowlers Stussy and McDaniel, who has started 9 straight in Hawaii. Christie is playing at that level, too. Robert Smith, who has already gone over 1,000 yards on the sideline after an injury, he may miss one more week, and then they hope to get him back. And now Mo Williams will open at running back. And Cunningham to throw on first down, screen to Williams. Blockers in front. Mo Williams! Dragged down at the 11-yard line by Tony Parrish after 64 yards.
Mike,
Michael, you go back to the first game when these two teams met. Robert Smith broke one about the same distance. Brian Billick, the offensive coordinator, wants to open up with it. Mo Williams does a nice job of getting behind the offensive line. And then instead of waiting for blocks, he accelerates. Randy Moss does a nice job of coming back. And you see him turn it on down the sideline. We talked about Randy Moss's ability to catch the football, but there he does a nice job of coming back to make the block on Minter.
The reason they had Williams in there is because he obviously has a lot more speed than Leroy Horde. And now Randall Cunningham wants a timeout. He didn't have the right personnel on the field, and the play clock was winding down.
Hello. Who is this?
What are you wearing?
Just a shirt and a pair of pants.
Oh, that's exciting.
Hello? Who is this?
What are you wearing?
A shirt and a pair of slates.
Oh, gabardine or herringbone?
Well, they're sort of a drapey tweed.
Slates Pants by Levi Strauss & Company. Time to get dressed.
Eldorado with the North Star system, now just $4.99 a month. It's still the legendary coupe for people who go their own way.
Jesus bears, it must be ma chérie.
Here, those bears. It's probably for me.
It's MCI, 5 cent Sunday. Whoa, whoa.
Remember, today is MCI 5 cent Sunday, the day you can jingle these bells for just 5 cents a minute.
It's MCI 5 cent Sunday.
If you're not an MCI customer, call 1-800-SUNDAYS.
College football's elite gather in Orlando, where Chris Lee and Kirk celebrate the nation's most outstanding performers. The Home Depot 1998 College Football Awards Show, Thursday at 8 on ESPN2.
The Vikings have just unveiled a secret weapon, as if they needed another one. That's Mo Williams from Kentucky, a third-year running back, number 3 on the depth chart. It's the first time he's touched the ball from scrimmage all year long. He goes 64 yards. First and 10, Vikings. Cunningham with time underneath to his tight end, Greg DeLong. Here's the Bears defense up front. Flanagan's been a playmaker and credits the addition of Wells as a run stopper. Barry Minter, their top linebacker, and understands the tradition of where he plays. Number 2 on the team in tackles. In the secondary, Walt Harris is having a Pro Bowl year and is the only defensive back with an interception. And Walt Harris is going to have some action on the corner. Ford is the deep man in the eye. Cunningham to throw again. Over the middle. Moore, touchdown!
Well, what Walt Harris does is he releases him. When Carter goes in motion, he releases him to Terry Cousins, and they don't pick him up inside, and he's wide open. Watch it. Here's Cousins, 21. He lets him get inside, and once that happens, it's over. It's over.
Randall Cunningham just puts a lot of juice on this one. That's the one thing when you talk to the wide receivers of the Vikings. They'll tell you that Randall can put a lot of heat on it.
Randy Moss has just regained the NFL lead in receiving touchdowns. He has a dozen for the season. Rookie of the year and perhaps the Pro Bowl as well. 7-0,
Vikes. We're ringing in the new year early and celebrating the arrival of the new 1999 Saturn SL at New Jersey's largest Saturn retailer.
Saturn of Route 23.
Saturn of Ramsey. Our resolution is to keep the 99 Saturn SL at the same low 98 lease price of only $129 per month. Your 1999 Saturn SL comes with full stereo, airbags, and air conditioning for only $129 a month at
Saturn of Route 23.
Saturn of Ramsey.
Sometimes doing the simple things can be difficult. No one should live with chronic pain or pain due to injury. The Pain Control Center at St. Mary's Hospital is here to help. They use many methods to treat and alleviate pain from arthritis, neck, arm, and shoulder, including whiplash injury, back pain, and more. Because no one should live with pain when help is available. The Pain Control Center at St. Mary's Hospital, 211 Pennington Avenue in Passaic.
Ever since she came home from the hospital, Mom's been her old self again, thanks to Visiting Health Services of New Jersey. When Mom was in the hospital, we had a choice in selecting our home care provider. The doctor explained the benefits of Visiting Health Services of New Jersey and made us feel comfortable with our decision. I guess you could say I'm really glad we chose them. I know Mom is.
Visiting Health Services of New Jersey, the right choice for certified home care.
Cunningham and Moss have hooked up a dozen times this year. Vikings take a 7-0 lead early on the Bears. 12 touchdown catches, 1,020 yards for Randy Moss, and almost four full games to go to add to those numbers in 1998.
Well, 12 catches, 12 games. This one, he's got a whole lot of game left.
And these two guys have got a lot of night left to worry about, too.
Dave Wannstedt, this is the last thing he wanted. He wanted to come out and be physical early on defense and somehow try to get the lead. Neither has worked. Mitch Berger to punt or to kick off to Milburn and Bones. Milburn will keep it in the end zone. Joe, there are ways to try to defend a guy. Sometimes they don't work.
Well, really, there are, Mike. What you want to do with Randy Moss, and we'll show you here on our ESPN pre-plays, you want to put a corner on him. There's Randy. And you want Walt Harris up in his face, which we saw initially. Then you want to back him up with Marty Card. Really put two guys on him. Let him bump him at the line, allow the man behind him to back it up, and then make a play on the ball. Here again, you bump him one time, cut him loose, then you play under him and behind him. What the Vikings did on offense is they ran Chris Carter out past him to take the double coverage off.
Bears will start from their own 20. Edgar Bennett. He'll lose two. Here's the Bears offense. Steve Stenstrom gets the start with Moses Moreno injured. He has one touchdown pass this year to go with three picks. With Enos on IR, Bennett is the featured back. Ingram has really emerged and has a chance for a 1,000-yard season. The strength up front is size. They are most powerful on the right side with Valerio and Williams. Draw play to Bennett. They'll lose three more. Crashing through Dixon Edwards. This is not establishing the run.
No, but they know that they're going to try to run the ball Chicago, and they're not going to throw the ball deep. So what they're doing, watch Dixon Edwards on the right-hand side of your screen. He's going to come in and just makes the play. He sees the hole, and as soon as he sees draw, he's there in the hole. I mean, behind the line of scrimmage.
John Randall, the wild one, getting ready to crank it up on 3rd and 15. Stenstrom throws to Conway. He'll make the catch, but it's 4 yards short of the first down out of the 26.
And the one thing that Dave Wannstedt told us yesterday, just don't make any mistakes in third and long. If we have to punt the ball 4, 5, 10 times in a game, that's okay, as long as we don't make a stupid mistake in our end.
Mike Horan, the oldest punter in NFL history. A couple of months, he will turn 40. Palmer pushed all the way back to his 23. Takes it out across the 33. Ty Halleck down on special teams after a 50-yard punt from Mike Horan. We've got a timeout. The Vikings already up 7-0.
The North Star System. Performance and technology that set Cadillac apart from every other luxury car in the world.
Now experience the difference during the Cadillac Performance Drive. With the 1999 Seville, with the power and control of the North Star system for just $549 a month. A powerful way to set yourself apart during the Cadillac Performance Drive. See your Cadillac dealer today.
The word is out in cyberspace. Buy.com is the internet superstore. Buy.com will deliver to your home or office. Whether it's the hottest videos and DVDs, the coolest video games, tons of great books, or the latest computer hardware and software, Buy.com has the lowest prices on earth. Buy.com. Why buy anywhere else?
If you're going to create electricity, use it. The Seiko Kinetic Watch. Electrically charged every time you move your body.
That last egg's looking real good. If you have a High Life light, maybe you will have room for just one more. See there? When you live the High Life, you can live it both ways.
It's my job to keep the plexiglass clean. In fact, I want it so clean you don't even know it's there. 10 minutes, he's back. He'll be fine. He'll walk it off. Fly away.
Mo Williams, who caught that 64-yard screen pass that electrified the crowd early, being taken off on the cart. We'll get an injury report on him as soon as possible. Brad Johnson, of course, has been injured off and on most of the year. He probably won't be healthy enough to start until the playoffs, and maybe not even then, so Cunningham is probably going to do it the rest of the year. Leroy Horde trying to get outside. He's tackled at the line, and a marker is down. Brian Robinson led the defensive charge for the Bears. Bob McElwee.
Number 82, offense, 10 yards, first down.
It's the tight end, Andrew Glover.
You know how powerful your offense is when you get a holding penalty, Joe, and it would have been second and 11 because Hoard doesn't go anywhere, but you're going to take the penalty anyway and make it first and 20.
Well, you got to give him as many yards as you can. You know, 11, that's nothing. Maybe they can't make 20. Maybe first and 20 is not makeable by them.
This may be the only team that would have plays to call on third and 30. Cunningham to Moss.
What a block by Chris Walsh. But I'm going to tell you what, looking at Randy Moss, Joe, there aren't many guys that come all the way across the field like this.
Well, the other thing is, too, all right, here's Chicago's game plan. We showed you on the prepay. Put Walt Harris in his face. That's fine. Can we tough him up? No. Watch now. Watch him dance. This is what's amazing about him. He flows through the entire Bear defense and then says, I'm not going to take a hit. I'm just going out of bounds.
Well, watch Chris Walsh, 81. Now, he's going to take Tony Parrish out. He just takes him out.
Walsh only 187 pounds, and Parrish is still down. He was depleted by Walsh on a crackback.
Well, I'll tell you, Walsh also grabbed his shoulder. But when you see the other guy down,
all of a sudden, it feels better.
Hey, my shoulder feels pretty good.
Okay,
look at it. You see, I'm rubbing your Lewis. Wow. This is a great setup, though. You know, you got Moss coming across the field. 37 is Parrish. Watch him just disappear.
And then his head is going to hit that turf. We'll check on Parrish when we come back. 7-0, Minnesota.
How would you feel if you found out you could have gotten a deeper discount on your vehicle and more for your trade? Discover the fun place to shop, the Bob Gisulli Auto Group.
When was the last time you had fun shopping for a car? Do you think you got the best price and payment? Did you get the most for your trade-in? Here's our special for you.
Lease the 1999 Toyota Camry for only $149 a month. Only at the Bob Gisulli Auto Group, the fun place to shop.
Hey, Carl, when you invited us over to watch the game, we were happy.
Oh, yeah.
But this TV's shot. It's heavy.
When are you going to get the home theater system, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, Carl, this system is awesome.
Where'd you get it?
6th Avenue Electronics. They've got a great selection and the best price. With their automatic price protection guarantee and expert installation, you can't lose.
6th Avenue Electronics.
Wow, Naomi, look at this service department. I've been all over this country, and I can honestly say I have never seen a service department cleaner, sophisticated, or better run than the one here at Cadis.
Wow, that's saying something, Coach Fossil, but it's really not surprising because Cadis has one of the highest customer satisfaction rate in the country. You can even have your nails done while you wait, or you can have lunch right here.
Well, I'll pass on having my nails done, but I'll take you up on that lunch.
Way to go, Coach. Cadis Ford Nissan, Route 23 South in Butler.
ESPN Sunday Night Football is brought to you by Slate's Pants, time to get dressed. By Cadillac and your Cadillac dealers. By MasterCard, there are some things money can't buy, for everything else this MasterCard. And by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of the Super Bowl. Sights of the season in Minnesota, and winter has arrived. It was cold today, and it's going to get a lot colder, a lot quicker. Leroy Horde pounds his way out to the 49-yard line, first down, where Brian Robinson makes the tackle. Chris Carter is out of the ballgame. We are told he strained a calf muscle during warm-ups and aggravated it in the game. And they've got it wrapped. They will continue to look at him, but his return right now is questionable. Ray Austin has checked into the lineup for the injured Tony Parrish in the Bears secondary. Parrish was able to get off the field under his own steam. Horde hitting the backfield, breaks another tackle. He has always run so very hard.
We have made so much about Randy Moss and Randall Cunningham and really the wide receivers and skilled, quote-unquote, positions on the offense. But this offensive line is pretty darn good. Todd Stussy and Randall McDaniel on the left side. Number 64 comes down. Stussy comes down. Then you see David Dixon come over. All of a sudden, it's 9 yards up the field by Leroy Horde.
David Palmer has come into the Minnesota lineup on second and one. They rely on him for big plays. Palmer will get the carry and fights for the first down. Appears to be short of our ESPN gold first and 10 line. That's Melanie Carter, Chris's wife, and his son Duran, who we had the pleasure of meeting the other day out at the Vikings camp.
I will say this, Duran said he has better hands than his dad.
Well, he's got great hands, Ben.
Got a great somebody to model after.
Let me tell you, look at those hands on Chris Carter. I mean, though he has big hands, he even said, well, Randy Moss, his hands aren't as big as mine. There aren't many guys in the league that have hands that big.
Yours are huge, though.
Huh?
Yours are huge.
Well, we're swollen.
There is Brian Billick. We talked about some hot coaching candidates during the year. The Vikings offensive coordinator will certainly be looked at by a lot of teams with openings this year. Billick says, of course, you know, every coach's goal is to be a head coach someday.
He's taken the Vikings on offense, I mean, with five different quarterbacks, 6 times to the playoffs.
Third down conversion, they are the best. Better than 50%. Horde is back in there. He'll go in motion. And they'll give it to Evans, the fullback, who stumbles forward and should have the first down. Charles Evans with only his 13th carry of the year. He has never fumbled in his NFL career.
And if you want to run the ball, you might as well go up the middle with McDaniel, Christie, and Dixon. I mean, it is the shortest distance between 2 points is a straight line. And just give it to Evans. They take Horde out of the backfield, which actually takes a linebacker out of play.
Mike Tice, the offensive line coach, said Stussy and McDaniel are playing up to their Pro Bowl image, but the Jeff Christie is the third guy that deserves to go to the Pro Bowl from this unit. The center is coming back off of a broken ankle last year. Cunningham for Moss, forced out of bounds and the pass overthrown. They had 2 guys on him that time.
What you really want to do is you really want to take Randy out of the offense as much as possible. This time Walt Harris just backs off. Now he's going to work him right to the sidelines. He's now out of bounds. He could not come back in and catch this pass unless it was touched by someone else. And Randall does the smart thing, just throws it inside where no one can get it.
Second and 10 from the Bears 40. Moss and Hatchett are the wideouts. Ford for a couple. ESPN Sunday Night Football continues next week with a huge battle in the AFC East. Vinny Testaverde and the Jets take on Dan Marino and the Miami Dolphins. Join Joe Theismann, Paul McGuire, and me right after primetime at 8:15 Eastern.
Well, are we looking forward to that one in a battle in the AFC East? Four teams scratching and clawing for it.
Two great coaches.
How about quarterbacks? They're not bad.
Cunningham on a half roll.
Throwing on the run. Moss got it at the sideline. Not just running ability or leaping ability, but look at the class with which he made that catch.
Well, if you just watch him and watch what he does, he gets his feet in bounds and he starts leaning towards the ball. Watch, here goes Moss. Just keep your eyes on, look at his legs, look at his feet. He sees where he is. Now watch this. He'll lean, catch the ball, I'm in bounds. There's nothing you can do about it.
Total awareness of what's going on the field. Look at that. That's a statuette picture.
Moss has already caught three for 38 yards. Cunningham has missed only one of six. Nice fake by Cunningham. Ford in the flat. 10, 5, touchdown!
Joe, if you're going to double cover on the outside and then you got Randall rolling to the side, there really is no one to pick up the back. Marty Carter misses the tackle, and that's no surprise.
Well, and they've run the ball enough up the middle so that you have to respect that play fake.
So many weapons, so few defenders. Cunningham has hit 6 out of 7 for 132 yards in the first quarter. There's still 6:20 to go, and the Vikings have exploded against the Bears defense, 14-0.
This is how Dale Earnhardt Jr. fans will remember the 1998 NASCAR Busch Series champion. This is how his opponents will remember him. From alternators and wire sets to batteries and spark plugs, get the parts that power Dale Earnhardt Jr. AC Delco powers the winners.
AT&T 00 Info, how can I help you?
Yes, I'd like the phone number of the Blue Lagoon Resort. I don't know the area code. Do I need to call Florida Information?
Now all you need is one number to get any local or long distance number. AT&T customers, dial 00. You never need the area code.
Got it. I'm there.
Dial 00 for any number, anywhere. We'll even connect you to your number for free.
Oh, oh, it's magic. You know.
Inspired performance and handling. Luxury with a whole lot of fun. It's what sets Caterra apart from every other car in its class. Now, experience the difference during the Cadillac Performance Drive with up to $4,500 in factory-to-dealer cash. Caterra with up to $4,500 in dealer cash, ready to move during the Cadillac Performance Drive. See your authorized Cadillac Caterra dealer today.
Okay.
The sign says the Bears are in grave danger. In truth, it may be worse than that. They're down 14-0 to the Vikings. It has taken Minnesota less than 8 minutes and 45 seconds to score 2 touchdowns. Berger
kicks one to St. Paul. You ask Dave once that his worst nightmare, he has just lived it in the first 8 minutes of this game. Everything that he said could not happen has.
But then all of a sudden you talk to Dennis Green, and this is exactly what Dennis Green wanted. He wanted to get up on the Bears. He didn't want to allow them to be able to run a play-action run game at him.
And their defense has always been predicated on being ahead and being able to take gambles and attack. Something John Randall loves. Stenstrom. Too strong for his rookie tight end, Alonzo Mays. The Viking defense counts on big plays up front from John Randall. He prefers playing tackle, but started at end tonight. The linebackers are small but very fast. McDaniel has taken over the middle spot to make way for Rudd on the outside. The secondary can be vulnerable, but it also makes big plays. Both Hitchcock and Griffith among the league leaders in interceptions with 5. Foj Fazio, the defensive coordinator for the Vikings. Very emotional, and he's got some weapons that can make big plays on D. Play action by Stenstrom. Ingram with a catch out to the 32. That will be a first down.
Joe, one of the things Minnesota's doing in this game is just they're playing man-to-man on the outside. These guys are single covering.
Well, they're really not man-to-man. It's a zone out there. You see him back up. You see Fuller giving a little bit of ground. He's looking into the backfield. They love to look back.
Andy Heck on John Randall. John Randall, Andy Heck said, you know, his hands never stop moving. And he doesn't stop moving.
Here comes the blitz. Edgar Bennett breaks the line of scrimmage and got it out to the 35-yard line where Randall makes the tackle. Now, Randall will be woofing at whoever he is across from. He will mention their wife's name, their kid's name, their hobbies, if they have a vacation home.
Well, look at on this blitz, Robert Griffith, number 24. As he's, watch these guys, they're blitzing up inside. Ed McDaniel is there, but they actually run by Edgar Bennett. When you're blitzing like that, you're coming up the middle, you've got to make sure the back doesn't get the ball first.
Bennett again, hit at the line of scrimmage, dives forward for maybe a yard, no more. Ed McDaniel, the undersized middle linebacker at 230, was right there.
Critical third down for the Bears. You don't want to turn the ball over here back to Minnesota's offense one more time. You got to give your defense a chance to catch their breath just a little bit. But you're in a very makeable down and distance at 35.
You know what's scary? There's 4:34 to go in the first quarter. You say it's a critical down, and you're right.
No, it is. At this point, this thing could get way out of hand in a heartbeat. You run a little play action here. You run a little drag pattern, pick up 8 or 9 yards.
Chris Penn is in as an additional wide receiver. He's number 86. Blitz, and they got there. Stenstrom never had a chance. Straight up the middle.
I'm going to tell you what, Ed McDaniel just flew up the middle. It was unbelievable. It looked like the whole thing just caved in. Ed McDaniel, number 58. Watch these guys come. He's right over the middle. Now, Bennett's going to try and block him. He goes up over top of him and makes a tackle in midair.
Horan will have to punt it away to Palmer. From the 33. Almost broke it. Got to the 39. Lemanski Hall made a saving tackle.
Randy Moss has showed us an awful lot so far in the first quarter. Here's how smart he is. He makes the move inside. Little quick move across. This shows you his speed and his ability to run away. And here he is, a technician of the game, knowing exactly where the sideline is and knowing how to control his body.
As a senior at Marshall, he caught 25 touchdown passes last year, which was an NCAA record. But the only time he had any trouble was with people bumping him on the line of scrimmage. It looked like he stalled that one. Leroy Horde out to the 43-yard line. When you look at the numbers that Randy Moss has put up this year, the things that he has done tonight, They've thrown him four balls. He's caught three for 38 yards, gotten 14 after the catch. Just the things he has done this year, you can't help but compare him to the greatest wide receivers that ever played this game.
And the problems that he presents to a defense, you can't overlook him. You have to account for him with two people.
Play action by Cunningham. Dumps it off to Horde. What an excellent decision by Randall Cunningham. 5 years ago, he doesn't make that play.
That is the biggest difference, I think, in Randall Cunningham this year from his previous years in football. He's only rushed for 77 yards this year. I can remember when he's rushed for 77 in a game, but he knows exactly where everybody is. He knows where his outlets are. He knows what he wants to do in the pocket. There he just dumps it off the Horde and lets Leroy take the punishment.
Awareness. He's aware of where everyone's at.
Out of football for a year, running a marble and tile business in his native Las Vegas. Ford again. And one thing Dennis Green wanted to see tonight, with Smith out with an injury, was could this team sustain long drives rather than the 18-second, 84-yard bomb. He wanted to see if they could take it down the field.
Their first scoring drive was nine plays. I think that fits into exactly what Dennis is looking for. This one here now has been five or six plays. So he's right on schedule to see another element of his offense.
One of the officials got wiped out in that play.
Tate comes in, number 83, as an additional wide receiver for Dennis Green. If you joined us late, Chris Carter hasn't played since the opening moments with a strained calf. They are already without Jake Reed. And there's the wrapping on Carter. Flag is down as Cunningham rolls. Throws complete to Chris Walsh.
It's holding, and I believe it's on Randall McDaniel.
Walsh gets very few opportunities to play, but he's a pretty good receiver. Played for Dennis Green at Stanford when he was there.
Holding, number 64, offense, 10 yards, second down.
Randall McDaniel's backing up, and he just pulls that. I think it's Mike Wells. But watch on the left-hand side of your screen, Randall McDaniel. Yeah, it is. Watch this. He just throws him to the ground, and you see the umpires right there and makes the call.
A tremendous wrestler at Arizona State. He has started nine straight Pro Bowls, which is a record. He'll be selected to this Pro Bowl. That's almost a given. It would be his 10th. That would tie an NFL record with Singletary and LT.
That's a technique you don't use in pro football, though.
No. Well, you do, but you get called for it. Cunningham to Walsh again at the 32. That will be a first down.
That just shows you how strong an arm Randall Cunningham has. There is not a whole lot of room for him to squeeze this pass in to Chris Walsh.
Yeah, but Joe, you know, if we talk about this game, look at the blocking at the offensive line. Look at the white shirts. They're not even close.
And then take a look at you looking right down the pipe. Look at the space he has to squeeze this thing into. Look at that. Right over the outstretched arms of Marion Forbes.
He hasn't been perfect so far, just 8 out of 9 for 170 yards. Moss, very short gain on that one. Couple of prestigious awards handed out next Saturday night at 6 Eastern, beginning on the Deuce with the Wendy's High School Heisman, the award that honors the best male and female scholar athletes in the nation. Then at 7:30 on ESPN, the exclusive presentation of the Heisman Trophy. Ricky Williams and the other contenders live from the Downtown Athletic Club in New York City. Other contenders indeed, because Ricky Williams is the only one that really needs to show up. What an incredible year he had. Ford hitting the backfield and dumped.
Yeah, I gotta go. Let me go back to the last play. They throw the ball to Randy Moss. Mike says not very much on that play. They hit 4 yards, Mike.
I mean, I know. Well, I know.
He's averaging 21.7 a catch. You hold him to 4 yards, you've done a great job.
It was just the way you said it, not very much on that.
That's right. And that's the end of the first quarter. The Vikings, trying to win their 12th game in 13 starts, have a 14-0 lead.
I often get asked, what type of investor am I? I want answers now. If I get the information today, I can act upon it. I can get the First Call report, the Argus report, the Vickers report. If Home Depot drops below a particular price, I want to be notified. If I wanted to buy, sell, or sell short, I just click on the option. Certainly, I'm not the same type of investor I was when I was 30, when I was 40, or when I was 50. I can go on.
With 6 wins this season and the 1998 NASCAR Truck Series Championship, it looks like the only truck that can stay ahead of Ron Hornaday's Napa Brakes truck is the 18-wheeler that hauls it. Now you can get a replica of Hornaday's NASCAR hauler for only $21.99 during Napa's holiday event. Napa, over 200,000 parts, and every one's important.
For great advice about digital technology, head for Circuit City. If you're looking for a DVD player, make sure you choose one with DivX. Only DVD players with DivX play both DVD and DivX movie discs. DivX lets you watch movies at home for about what it costs to rent, but you never have to return movies or pay late fees. This RCA DVD player with DivX is only $399.99, and get any 5 DivX movies free after rebate. Plug into DivX at Circuit City.
Randy Moss fell to the 21st pick in the draft because of the problems he had had off the field in the past. I think coming to the Minnesota Vikings was a perfect situation.
Well, Dennis Green called him after the draft. He told him, well, we're going to draft you, and we're not going to put you in a pressure situation. We've got Jake Reed and Chris Carter. You're going to be the third receiver.
And the other thing is, Chris Carter played a very big part in this because after the minicamp, he took Randy Moss down to his place in Boca Raton, which is a workout facility, and he started teaching him how to be a professional. And he also wanted to develop a relationship with him and let him know that he would be there to help him.
He is the best rookie wide receiver I ever saw. He's covered right now by Wal Harris. They throw instead to the other side, and that one is complete to Matthew Hatchett, who makes his first catch of the year. So even without Chris Carter, even without Jake Reed, they find other weapons.
But still, you got to take a look at Matthew Hatchett. He's 6'2", he's almost 200 pounds, another big receiver. Hard to muscle him because he physically can get away from the press corners.
And when we look at Cunningham's doing, you know, he's missed one pass. That's one he actually threw away because Moss was out of bounds.
Another first down for the Vikings. Leroy Hoare pounds his way inside the 15. This is what Randy Moss said on the guidance and influence of his teammate and his new friend, Chris Carter.
With him being by my side, and also on and off the field, I think if I'd have went somewhere else, I don't think that I would be in the spotlight that I'm in right now. But with the help of him, through the off season here in training camp and then coming here to start our season, man, it's been a lot of help, and I thank you for that. It's been a lot of help for me.
A great relationship between those two. Hoard runs into his own man and drops in his tracks. Greg DeLong, the tight end, was coming across the formation and just blasted him.
Well, yeah, but the thing about it is DeLong gets knocked back in to Hoard.
I don't think Leroy cares about the cause.
Well, Sean Lee, number 76, he is just coming up the field. He's only playing run. Watch this. Bam, bam, and Hoard hits DeLong, Sean Lee hits Dixon, and that's a loss.
And if Hoard is unable to go, that means David Palmer is the only other tailback type on the ball club, because Mo Williams was taken off earlier. We're still waiting on a physical report on him. Robert Smith is already out with an injury for at least another week.
Well, Mike, here's good news, bad news. If David Palmer isn't going to go a lot, you go with Charles Evans at the fullback position, and you wind up throwing the ball a lot more. I'm not sure if that plays in Chicago's favor much either.
There is Mo Williams, and he's got the shoe and the sock. The tape is off, ice on the top of the foot. And here is Palmer checking into the lineup. Well, you're right. Having Palmer on the field more is extremely dangerous.
He's only carried the ball seven times to date and has 11 receptions. But those 11 receptions have all been for third down conversions.
Third and long, they're the best. They're the best on regular third downs, and these as well. Palmer goes in motion. Here comes the blitz. Cunningham unloads. Got the pass out to Hatchett. He'll be a couple yards shy of a first down. Good tackle by Randy Hilliard.
And this is just an audible by Randall Cunningham. He looks out and sees the one-on-one coverage, and he's going to take a chance in Hatchett. He's going to say, all right, I'm going to let you go one-on-one and try and pick it up. That time it didn't happen.
You know what we just heard? They're booing a field goal. Wait, these guys are good, but you put points on the board.
This is the only perfect kicker in the National Football League. Gary Anderson has hit 21 in a row. The NFL record is 20 or 31. He has hit 26 over 2 years. And if you notice, they go right down the heart of the upright. That thing could be a foot and a half wide. He'd split it anyway. 17-0 Minnesota.
In a small town,
they're after me.
Something terrifying has happened to the faculty.
Aliens are taking over the school.
Now.
Where are your friends?
It's spreading everywhere.
By morning, there won't be a human left.
There's nowhere to run!
The faculty.
This is weird.
Rated R. In theaters everywhere, Friday, December 25th.
Hi, I'm Doug Flutie, pro football player and father of an autistic child. A lot of people buy Flutie Flakes because a portion of the proceeds go to help autistic children. But there's another way you can help. Dial 1010-220 when you call long distance. You can talk up to 20 minutes for only 99 cents.
And every time you use it, a donation will be made to the Doug Flutie Jr. Foundation.
So dial 1010-220, talk up to 20 minutes for only 99 cents, and help some great kids at the same time. It's a win-win situation. I wish football was this easy.
It is more than a trial by fire. It is a rite of passage. And if you can master your fear, outsmart your enemy, and never yield even to yourself, you will be changed forever. The few, the proud, the Marines.
ESPN Sunday Night Football is brought to you by the new sci-fi thriller, The Faculty, in theaters everywhere, December 25th. By 1-800-COLLECT, the easy way to save. By the United States Marine Corps, where the change is forever. And by Dell, direct computer solutions for business at home. Be direct, Dell. In the Metrodome in Minneapolis, where the Vikings are laying it to the Bears 17-0. Berger with another big kickoff.
Michael, what a great combination this is. You have Gary Anderson, who has not missed a field goal this year, kicks him down the middle, so there really is no decision for the officials. Just put your arms up as soon as he kicks. Then you got a punter that is excellent, and he has kicked more touchbacks in the National Football League this year than anyone else. But this guy, not only does he kick it into the end zone deep, but high. So if it ever does go short, he's going to have 10 guys down there covering.
Yeah, but what's scary is you were trying to coach him at breakfast yesterday.
I taught him how to do this, that stuff they were doing.
Gary Zauner had his fingers in their ears hoping they weren't listening to him.
Bennett and Halleck are the running backs for the Bears, who are desperate to get something started on offense. Central. Tipped and incomplete. Fuller got a hand on it and knocked it away. And when you start throwing outs against the Vikings and when they're playing zone, you're asking for it.
Well, what they try and do is they try and split the double coverage here. Corey Fuller is up. He's backed up with safety help. Now he's looking in the backfield. He lets Ingram go outside and just falls back. There you see the safety coming over Orlando Thomas. But it's a double zone. You see Minnesota play a lot of zone. They're about a 30% man team, 70% zone. They don't want to give up the big play.
Fuller with three interceptions this year. Stenstrom with the screen. Bennett, nothing. They lose two. McDaniel made the tackle, but Rudd was the guy who messed up the timing.
Dwayne Rudd, you know, they've been talking about Rudd, how good he is. And McDaniel, Ed McDaniel, 58-57. Watch these guys work together. They read screen. Here comes Rudd here. He turns him into McDaniel. Is that a great combination?
Well, Coach Fajo, when we talked to him the other day, said that the play of Rudd and McDaniel has really elevated this defensive unit. These guys are their playmakers, and they have to make plays for the defense to be good.
The Bears have run nine plays. Only four have gained yardage. And now Chicago will use the timeout as the play clock is winding down. The wheels are coming off the Bears machine.
Parkway Toyota, New Jersey's oldest and finest Toyota dealer, presents the rugged 1999 Toyota Fun Vehicles. The powerful new V8 Land Cruiser, the 4Runner, luxury and toughness, the RAV4, the compact sport ute, and the Sienna, the Toyota of minivans. They're all here for you to buy or lease at Parkway Toyota every day. Come to Parkway Toyota, because we give you more.
We got the gift that needs the winter.
Your last car dealer a little over-eager to make a deal?
Come here, if I get a deal for you, let's make a deal. You can drive this baby home today.
Hey, who needs that? Discover the fun place to shop, the Bob Gisulli Auto Group.
When was the last time you had fun shopping for a car? Do you think you got the best price and payment? Did you get the most for your trade-in? Here's our special for you.
Lease the 1999 Toyota Camry for only $149 a month. Only at the Bob Gisulli Auto Group, the fun place to shop.
These overhead shots provided by the Dell Aerial Cam high above the Metrodome for ESPN Sunday Night Football. It has been all Vikings. Minnesota on top 17-0. I didn't know my wife was here. She's the only member.
Janet. Janet's at the game.
Movement up front. Big Cat Williams jumped, but there were a couple of guys leaning in his face at the time.
I think John Randall might have thrown him off.
All start, 71 offense, 5 yards, third down.
John Randall was right over him, and he moves, and then Williams moves.
See, Dave Wannstedt's really in a quandary on offense, as is Matt Cavanaugh, the coordinator. The problem is, if you get to the line of scrimmage and try and go on a quick count, you don't really give your guys a chance to set up. If you go on a longer count, because of the noise, you keep them down there so long they can't hear the quarterback.
Stenstrom trying to air this one out, intended for Chris Penn, but he was cut off as he tried to make his second move by Jimmy Hitchcock, who's been just a tremendous acquisition from New England.
There was a lot of courage by Stenstrom to double pump Joe against this defense, and you know you're going to get hammered, and they really haven't blocked him much.
Horan on the punt again. Palmer waits at his 45. Low kick. Palmer at midfield. A lot of room to run. And gets inside the 40. 37-yard line drive punt and a 12-yard return. Randy Moss in that Viking offense exploding for 17 first-half points.
I'm a CEO.
I'm an engineer.
I'm a student.
We needed a server-based network.
Powerful workstation.
A notebook with DVD.
For 16,000 people.
But what I wanted.
What I needed.
I couldn't find. Then Dell came to see me.
So I called Dell.
I went to Dell on the internet.
And they built it.
And they built it.
Just for me.
Just for us.
And amazingly enough.
This direct way.
This direct way.
Actually costs less.
Actually costs less.
That's genius.
Be direct. Dell. Dell computers use Intel Pentium 2 processors.
Sir, I think that I could be a real asset to your company.
Jenkins, I think we can use a man like you.
Thank you. Thank you.
For about the price of an ordinary hotel, Residence Inn offers you a living room, too, just in case you need one. Residence Inn by Marriott. Room to relax, room to work, room to breathe.
Introducing the Nissan Frontier V6. With shift-on-the-fly four-wheel drive and 200 foot-pounds of torque, it's the perfect truck for those really big jobs. The Nissan Frontier V6.
ESPN's Sunday Night Football. This week, Dan Marino and Vinny Testaverde square off when the Dolphins and Jets battle for a leg up in the AFC East title hunt. ESPN's Sunday Night Football. Coverage begins at 8:15.
Well, I got to remember to watch that game.
That's the Vikings owner, Red McCombs, a businessman out of San Antonio, Texas, who tried and failed on several occasions to get into the NFL club. He got into it this year, and the first thing he said was, I don't see why we can't win them all. He's only missed once, and he has really revitalized his ball club. The players think the world of it. Cunningham, a wobbler to Moss. Randy Moss to the 17-yard line, a gain of 23.
Boy, if you don't get in Randy's face, he's just going to eat up a lot of yards. He's so fast. This time Walt Harris backs off. He just pushes him, makes a little move to the post, then squares it off, and then just glides up in the air to make the reception.
I just think what Chris Carter said about Randy Moss and also Dennis Green is that really nobody knows how fast this guy really is.
I'm anxious to see he and Deion lock it up. That's what I want to see.
Leroy Horde back in, and he'll get the carry. Ford hurdles his own man and gets inside the 15-yard line. Cunningham so far is at 12 out of 13 for 213 yards in about 19 minutes of action. Moss with four catches for 60 yards.
Well, you know, we talked to Cunningham yesterday, and you saw him on what, the Thursday game, the Thanksgiving game.
He's
smiling because he saw one-on-one with Randy Moss outside.
You'd smile too, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Here comes the blitz. Cunningham unloads out to the outside. Hatchet forced out of bounds at the two by Terry Cousins.
Well, the Bear corners, Mike, they're playing off. They're playing real soft. They're playing off 7-8 yards. And Rainbow Cunningham is really a guy who's saying, listen, if you don't want to come up and challenge him, then I'll just take it. Look at how far off Cousins is. Cousins doesn't even back up. He has to move forward to try and make the tackle on Hatchet.
Well, he also had Randy Moss on the other side on Walt Harris one-on-one.
Chris Carter, all he's doing right now is being a cheerleader on the sideline. But he's doing a good job of that, too. Leroy Horde. Cut down at the three. Mike Wells was in on the stop, number 97 for the Bears. Dennis Green got a contract extension after Red McCombs bought the team. His future very much in doubt under the old ownership.
Hey, Dennis has said, listen, I have been fighting here for 7 years. He's a fighter. He's battled and battled and battled. And Red has really taken a liking to him. Matter of fact, Red went up to him and said, Dennis, if you don't want me in the locker room, just let me know. Dennis said, no, we'd love having you around.
Second and goal. Coming into the corner, Hatchett can't get it. Nice play by Terry Cousin.
You know, one other thing about Red McCombs and Chris Carter, we were talking to him yesterday, and he just said, you know, he makes such a difference here. He said, I'm in the locker room, and he calls and says, hey, you guys are doing a great job. Yeah. No one has ever done it before.
Good job by Cousins. Now he gets 1-on-1, does a nice job of turning back when Hatchett turned back to make a play on it. Randall hesitated just a second. He has such confidence in his receivers that they can make plays.
Third and goal. This one thrown, and Walsh was held by Randy Hilliard. No flag.
Don't you love Randy Hilliard voiced himself? Hey, I covered him. Yes, you did.
He sure did. Walsh tried to turn toward the middle of the end zone and never had the chance.
Well,
Randy Hilliard, you see him up on the right part. It'll come in the right part of your screen. Randall's trying to make the throw. I mean, Randy Hilliard is not even looking. Chris Walsh is trying to get to the ball. Now, you know, I'm not quite certain what anybody's real definition is of pass interference. I think it's an interpretive rule, an interpretive penalty, and I don't know what the interpretations are for different officials. That one looked like it to me.
Gary Anderson splits the uprights again, 23 in a row this year.
What were the skies like when you were young?
There were lots of stars at night, and when it would rain, it would all turn. They were beautiful, the most beautiful skies, as a matter of fact. The sunsets were purple and red and yellow and fire. The clouds would catch the colors everywhere. That's it, neat, because I used to look at them all the time. You don't see that.
P.C. Richard & Son has all the holiday gifts. You get the holiday savings. Check your newspaper for a 16-page circular filled with hundreds of holiday sale specials. Sharp 19-inch color TVs, just $169. GE cordless phones, $29. Samsung microwave oven, $74. Iowa Shell stereo with 3 CD, just $179. For all your holiday gifts, come to P.C. Richard & Son.
We got the gift at P.C. Richard.
The store of choice for both big and tall men invites you to the grand reopening of the He-Man Big and Tall Shop at 255 Route 4, opposite Fuddruckers in Paramus. Choose from the biggest selection of big and tall fashions in North Jersey. Palm Beach, Burberry, Talia, Jack Victor, Sansibel, Franco Tassi, and much more. Our friendly staff cater to your fashion requirements and do expert alterations while you wait. Don't miss the big sales event at the He-Man Big and Tall Shop, where fashion comes first.
This week, live from the Blue Horizon, Camazales takes on DeJesus. Plus, Archie Moore, a retrospective. Friday Night Fights, Friday at 8 on ESPN2.
Beautiful St. Paul Cathedral in St. Paul, Minnesota. One of the twin cities here, along with Minneapolis, of course. Beautifully lit at night. And for the Christmas season approaching. Berger, who has put them all in the end zone so far.
There's another one.
Brushes another one. And when you don't even have a chance for a run back on special teams, you've taken a big part out of a team's game plan.
Well, I'll tell you what else is amazing. They're 8.5 minutes to play in the second quarter, and the Bears have only run 11 plays.
And only four of them have gained yards. They have 12 yards passing, 12 total yards in the ball game. The Bears have not crossed their own 36.
As compared to Minnesota's 248, is that what you're saying?
Yes. Cunningham on a pace for about 8,000 yards in this game. James Allen is the new running back, a young man they have high hopes for. Instead, they'll give it to the fullback, Ty Halleck, and he gets about a yard. Monday Night Countdown. Tomorrow night at 6:30 p.m. Eastern. Join Mike Tirico, Tom Jackson, and Sterling Sharp for the latest word around the league. Then at 8 on ABC, it's Monday Night Football. Brett Favre and the Packers battle Warwick Dunn and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. ABC and ESPN, your exclusive network for primetime NFL football. Stenstrom with a short set goes out in the flat to his tight end Alonzo Mays, and the rookie from Oklahoma State will have a first down.
You know, this is about all Stenstrom has time to do. A four-yard pattern and hope that they can get a first down with it.
I think that the Bears on first and 10 have to throw the football. I don't think they have to run it. I think you can flash the ball in some semblance of play-action type passing. But the offensive line is not able to tee off on that defensive line because of the lead the Vikings have.
They'll whistle this play dead. And of course, what the Vikings do when they get a lead.
All start, 85, offense. 5 yards, first down.
They just totally forget about the run, and they're going for sacks. They're going for penetration to blow up plays.
Coach Fazio, defensive coordinator. All right, here they are. John Randall will make you move. And Dwayne Clements, number 92, he's the guy that stepped up. I mean, when you look at it,
he'll make you move.
He'll make you move, too. They're all big enough. I'll tell you what's amazing. Watching these three linebackers, 57, 8, 9, Edwards, McDaniel, and Rudd.
First and 15 for the Bears. Allen shakes one tackle and drilled as he got to the 29. He had been on the practice squads at both Tennessee and Philadelphia before being released by those clubs, signed to this practice squad.
And I think the Bears have reached a point in their season where they have to find out about some people. They have to find out about Stenstrom. Can he be a quarterback for them, or are they going to have to go look for one? You know, can James Allen be some kind of a back that they can keep on this roster? That's really what Dave Wannstedt is taking a look at now. He's got to see if he's got players for next year.
He would have loved to have had Curtis Enos for the full year, but of course Enos was injured, tore up a knee, facing a 10-month rehabilitation. Stenstrom swings it to Allen in the flat, incomplete. Corey Fuller would have been right there anyway.
Oh, that's one great way of losing a running back. Because if he has to stretch with Fuller there, he's going to get nailed.
I'll tell you what else it is. That's a quarterback who feels so uncomfortable in the pocket that he doesn't really set for the rhythm to be able to get the ball out and see the receiver. Moses Marino played last week. Really has an ankle problem that has moved back to the almost the Achilles area. And I was watching him in warm-ups. If he had to get in there, it would be very ugly.
He's listed as the third quarterback tonight, with Jim Miller recently signed as the backup. Stenstrom under pressure, and they've got him at the 15. The ball comes loose.
I'm going to tell you what. I just watched John Randall, and you are about to see one of the great spin moves of all time. Todd Perry, number 75, is the left guard. But what John Randall does, watch how quick he really is. This is where he's dangerous inside. Perry's on the left. Look at his move. Wing. He's already by him. He's by. He's got the sack.
Stenstrom had a knee down, it appeared.
Such quickness. Perry didn't even have a chance to move his feet. And John was there.
Stenstrom's left knee appeared to be well on the ground before that ball came out. But Clemens picks up the loose ball. Chicago turns it over. And now they are going to overrule it, and that's a good call.
Watch his knee. He still has control of the ball. The left knee is on the ground, and then the ball comes out. That's a good job by the official.
Horan to punt to Palmer. A much better kick this time. Crushed it. Palmer all the way back to the 29. 8-yard return after a 54-yard boomer. Ricardo McDonald with the tackle.
Randy Moss just continues to show every element of his game. They want to try and challenge him. The Bears put Walt Harris up on him. They get physical with him. That's one way to do it. Now you try, you can't get a hand on him. He makes the catch inside. Now you play off him, and he just works the middle of the football field on you. Everybody thinks they've come up with a different way to try and attack him. To be honest with you, I thought getting up in his face might be a way to stop him a little bit, but I'm not convinced there's any way now.
One out of two against the press. When they let him go, he's caught them all. Ford is back in there at running back. They throw him the screen. Leroy Horde fighting for extra yardage out to the 43. Mike Wells chased him down.
You know, Mike, watching Randy Moss, I guess it's his show, but watching him warm up and watch him catch, everything is with his hands. And they are so soft, and they talk about people with soft hands. It just looks so effortless. We're watching him catch ball after ball in warm-ups, and it's just like there's nothing to it.
He has already caught passes for 1,074 yards this year. Cunningham on a little half roll after a nice play fake. Throws for Hatchett, incomplete. Very well covered by Cousin.
Randall Cunningham has really, really stepped up his game this year. When he came in, played the latter three games last year, he didn't understand the offense. He didn't know the personnel. They didn't know him. And really, Brian Belick was really limited in what he could do for Randall. He had a very difficult time being able to understand what Randall knew as far as this offense went. Now they know they're on the same page, and look at the production.
Palmer comes in on 3rd and 5. Walsh in as well. He's in motion. 4-man rush. No pressure on Cunningham. Throws underneath. That's going to be short of a first down. Palmer made the catch, but right there was Andre Collins, the linebacker.
They're going to be short a yard. I mean, there's not even a measurement here.
Mitch Berger will come on for the first time tonight to punt. This is only his 43rd punt of the year. Milburn drops deep back to the 10.
Well, with this offense, if he doesn't kick off, he doesn't get much work.
Exactly.
You know? Look at this kick.
Too good. Knocks it into the end zone. And the Bears, after a 53-yard punt, will start at the 20. And there is a marker down.
Now, what did I tell him yesterday?
You told him to aim for the sidelines. I was there when you told him that.
Exactly. Don't kick the ball in the end zone. Aim for the sideline. And he didn't listen.
You know what he told me secretly? I'm not listening to you. So he told me. I thought I'd share that with you now.
The preliminary signal against the Vikings, a personal foul.
He said, you want to back 15 yards and make
personal
the kick
foul.
Again?
Number 81 on the kicking team, 15-yard face mask foul. 15-yard penalty, fourth down.
Chris Walsh called for a face mask. They'll make them punt it again. Another great doubleheader of college basketball for you. Tuesday night starting at 7:30, number 11, Indiana, against the defending national champion Wildcats of Kentucky, followed by Iowa against number 8, Kansas, at 9:30. And speaking of college basketball, a huge win today for Gary Williams and his Maryland Terrapins. They are playing such brilliant basketball, and what a club he has put together, ranked number 2 this week. Now Berger will have a chance to really air it out.
Where do you want him to kick it now, Paul?
Now you can kick it high.
Down the middle.
Yeah, down the middle.
The Bears with 8 men on the line, and they're coming. They didn't get there. Just much lower. Milburn. Whacked at the 31. An 8-yard return, a 44-yard punt. Dwayne Butler applied the shot along with Kay Mays. Updated through today's game, here are the NFC playoff stats. The Vikings, of course, with a win tonight would go to 12-1. The Falcons with the division lead in the West, 11-2. The Cowboys at 8-5 after that loss. Here's the wild card. San Francisco, and Green Bay. Then it falls to Arizona, New Orleans, and Tampa Bay, all with seven losses. The Lions and the Giants at 5-8 still in it. Somebody has to step up to be that third wild card team. Draw play to Allen. He'll get a couple out to the 34.
In the NFC, potentially 7-9 could be a wild card team this year. In the NFC, 7-9. Don't look. You're looking at me.
Why, if you're 7-9, why don't you just let them go to a bowl game?
Because they might not win it.
Well, they're 7-9. They're not going to win anything. That's right. They may get beat in the bowl game.
Cruel. You are cruel.
If you're 7-9, I wouldn't hold out a lot of hope in the second season. Stenson fumbles the snap from center. There's a flag down. They'll blow the play dead.
Everybody moved on Chicago.
False start, right guard. 5 yards penalty, second down.
Chris Valerio called for the false start.
Olin Cruz is the center, number 58. 57, excuse me. He doesn't even get it back to Stenson. Doesn't even get it there. You know, when you've got people all over you, when you've got people up on your nose, I think that is the toughest thing for a center to do. To anticipate where he's going to block, but also get the ball to the quarterback first.
Hurts at only 21, a rookie out of the University of Washington, in there for Casey Wegman. Stenson dumps it off to Allen. He can't hold it.
I mean, you just look at the frustration on Dave Wannstedt's face. I mean, you know, because when they came into the meeting with us yesterday, they were very convinced that they were going to win this football game, or at least play extremely well.
That's right.
But if you're Matt Kavanaugh, what do you call? It's third down and 13. You know they're going to pin their ears back.
Quick kick.
I mean, you're almost in a situation to do that. But, you know, you really have to get your offensive line to just slow them down so that you can at least get the ball off.
Bennett and Halleck are the split backs. Four-man rush. Stenson with a little time throws to Conway, incomplete.
You know, when he threw that ball to Conway, in the area, there were five purple shirts. Five. I mean, just in the area. There's got to be someone open somewhere. Watch where this ball is thrown. Conway will turn inside and look at the guys that end up there.
Yeah, but Curtis Conway makes a mistake on that play. He does not come back for the ball. It allows Hitchcock to come over the top and make the play.
The Bears right now have 15 yards in total offense. Palmer driven back to his own 19. Still on his feet at the 25. There's a flag down back at the 21. 6-yard return after a nice 52-yard punt. Ty Halleck on the tackle.
Illegal block in the back, number 55, during the return. 10-yard penalty, first down.
That will back the Vikings up. These overhead shots provided by the Dell Area Cam. With us tonight for ESPN's Sunday Night Football game from the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Crystal clear night here in the Twin Cities.
You see that meteor go by?
You know, I'm so afraid that it's going to hit one of those buildings one of these times. It does. I mean, don't you expect? It's like, whoo, boom,
it's beautiful.
Chris Carter, who has seen minimal action tonight.
What a sensational player he is.
Randy Mossum.
He really is. Chris Carter is a special person, a great player.
Carter has a string of 111 straight games without a catch that's in jeopardy right now if he remains on the sideline. Cunningham short set to Moss. Well, I'll tell you what, Walt Harris has done a pretty nice job on it.
Yeah, but I mean, Randall Cunningham decides that he wants to see just how hard he can throw this one to Randy Moss. Randy usually catches the ball and his hands don't move back very far. On this one, you see his hands kick back a little.
Let's look at the center, number 62, pointing out. Look, he's calling the defenses.
He's calling plays for the offensive lineman. Now Randall takes over, and they throw to Moss.
Ford lowers his head and moves the pile forward to the 20.
The thing about Jeff Christie is when he was out of the lineup, recognition of defensive fronts is a big part of pass blocking. And with the center out, that meant that Randall Cunningham had to pick up the responsibility. Now that Jeff Christie is back in there, it allows Randall to focus on the secondary. He doesn't have to worry about the defensive line and the linebackers. That's handled by Christie and the guys up front.
We have reached the two-minute warning. Vikings in control.
It's hard to respect the French when you have to bail them out of two big ones in one century. But we have to hand it to them on mayonnaise. Nice job, Pierre.
You change your oil every 3,000 miles, right? No, do you? You push it. Now you're so busy, you try to squeeze another 1,000 miles out of your oil. Or more. Well, squeeze this. It's to do it yourself when you have the time. Reformulated Quaker State. Protection beyond 3,000 miles under any driving conditions. Anybody say insurance? It's been tested. And unlike that lazy uncle nobody really likes to talk about, it works. So go get some. Quaker State. Sensible technology. What more do you need to know?
EA Sports presents Tiger versus Cyber Tiger.
Hey, Tiger. You ever think about caddying?
Don't make me come over there.
Step aside. It's combo time.
Combo?
Check it out. Get him.
Oh, that combo.
Tiger Woods, 99. PGA Tour Golf. Beat him or beat him. EA Sports. It's in the game.
Here's the 90s way to trim a beard. The 1890s. Today, there's the new Norelco Beard and Mustache Trimmer. With 9 adjustable settings, Norelco gives you the look you want. Norelco, put it to the test.
Me and you should hang out in off-season together.
I don't think you're going to be retired.
What's that?
Johnny Carr.
No. But I'm telling you, I'm being polite and cordial. We should go fishing together.
Welcome back to Minneapolis for our ESPN Sunday night telecast. The Vikings with the football at their own 20. Palmer is in there as a third down back. They'll give it to Evans, the fullback, instead. Gets a block from Moss and forced out of bounds across the 30 first down Vikings.
Boy, did they just cave in the whole left side, the offense's left side, the right side of the defense. But Sean Lee, number 76, is the end. And they watch this. Look at 76. Watch him just take him down inside. I mean, that's incredible. Stussy, 73. They just block inside. Actually, it was Matt Burke who was in, 75.
Christie threw a heck of a block as well. Look at this, 278-15 in total yards in the first half. Cunningham, excellent protection. Now he steps up and runs. There's a marker down. Cunningham across midfield will check the penalty. It's a gain of 20 if it stands.
It's going to be holding against the Bears, so it will stand.
Holding, number 21 defense. That'll be 5 yards from the end of the run. First down.
Now, lower part of your screen, there's the grab. Cousins just hangs on to Hatchett.
They want to watch Randy Moss. This is what he does. Watch it. Get off the line of scrimmage. He knows that Harris is going to be up on him. But look at how quickly he gets by him, Joe.
Cunningham, the all-time NFL leader in rushing yards for a quarterback. Over the middle. Complete to the tight end. Glover inside the 10. Tony Parrish had to make the stop after a gain of 36.
You know, Andrew Glover, you don't talk about him. He doesn't jump up much. That was his 29th catch. He has three touchdowns. Take a look at it. If you double cover the outside, what's going to happen is you allow that tight end to go right down the middle when the safety's void. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him, and you're really asking your middle linebacker almost an impossible task. He goes right down the middle on Marty Carter, who's in the nickel, and it just doesn't matter.
Ford and Evans are the running backs on first and goal. Cunningham to Horn. Leroy Horn pulls his way to the three, going a little deep in the playbook for the option.
Brian doesn't want us to see what the next one is.
He may have been laughing.
Well, you know, you look at it, that play, I mean, it just works. Charles Evans goes one way, and it looks like a quarterback option. Look at Evans, 29. He goes up into the middle, and he just turns around and flips it to Hort.
It was a quarterback option, except Randall says, I'm going to take it. That's one option that's not in there.
Cunningham, short set for Moss. Randy Moss just got rid of Walt Harris.
Walt Harris is going to get penalized. He got his helmet off.
He thought he was pushed. The second touchdown catch of the night.
And there's no way Walt Harris should not have a 15-yard penalty. I mean, he still has his helmet off. He took it off in protest to the official. The official looked right at him and did absolutely nothing.
Moss, 13 catches for touchdowns in his first 13 games. Take a look and see if Moss gets away with one on the replay against Walt Harris.
One-on-one, they're going to work outside. Randy Moss tried to shake him. He just comes down. You know, Walt Harris does a good job, I think, of backing off. Here's a better look at it. Does Randy push him? Not really. I think it was just incidental contact.
I just think, you know, it is. Look at the pass by Cunningham. Harris is back off. He's hoping to get a call. He doesn't get one.
Chris Carter is just loving watching his pupil and his friend develop as a pro.
And he thought initially that it was going to be a father and son relationship between he and Randy. It really has become one more of brothers, which works very well for both of them.
Randy Moss said his goal, very simple, come in and rip up the NFL. He's achieved it.
He's only felt like one game that he's played to the level that he thinks he can play, and that was their last Green Bay game.
And when you look at his numbers and realize that he was part of the third three wide receiver package, he wasn't even a full-time player.
You know, one of the things about him, when you talk to players, and you always ask them, do you think, you know, would you like to play the perfect game? The players said, you know, guys, 15 years, I've never played the perfect game. This guy's going to do it one of these days.
He could be real close tonight.
See if Berger can put another one in the end zone. This one to the one. Milburn across the 20 to the 23. Bobby Houston made the tackle on special teams. To say Randy Moss came into this league looking to make an impact might be a little of an understatement when you listen to his goal.
To rip the NFL up. That was my main goal. Wasn't anything about scoring touchdowns or making this team pay or anything like this. I just wanted to come here and rip the NFL completely up.
Now that's a big statement, you know, for anybody to make. But if you can back it up, and Lord knows he can back it up.
If you just listen to that, you sense, boy, this kid's cocky. He is not arrogant. I had a chance to sit with him during the interview, spend time with him in the locker room. This kid is a very humble, focused, great football player.
The Bears just want to get this half over with.
Well, if he's going to rip it up, he's taking a big tear out of it already.
That's the end of the first half. The score, Minnesota 27, Chicago nothing. Join Chris Berman for the Mercedes-Benz halftime report.
All right, Michael, thank you very much. This just in, the Minnesota Vikings
they're good. So are the Denver Broncos. They're real good, beginning the day at 12-0. You know what happened a couple of Monday nights ago? They rolled the Kansas City Chiefs, but a lot of late hits in the fourth quarter, so kind of a grudge match in this AFC West rivalry. You also know the history of Marty Schottenheimer at Mile High Stadium, 2-9. But if the Chiefs could salvage anything this season, it would be to dethrone the Broncos, who are trying to become only the third team in NFL history to start the year at 13-0. The other two, the 1934 Chicago Bears, who lost in the championship game to the Giants in the sneaker game, and, of course, the 1972 Miami Dolphins. It was the Broncos at home, Mike Shanahan, Gary Kubiak, the offensive brain trust. Well, what they watched was Kansas City score early. Rich Gannon play action so well, this Andre Rison, 7-0 Chiefs. John Elway, Broncos down 21-14. Deasy Ed McCaffrey, another big game for him, touchdown 21 all at the half. Terrell Davis at the one, he fumbled. First fumble in 836 touches, so the Broncos do not take the lead in the third quarter. Next drive, Shanahan sees Kansas City continue to score touchdowns. Gannon, Joe Little Bighorn, 28-21 Chiefs. Fourth quarter, 10-point lead for Kansas City, 31-21. Elway, Willie Green, Dale Carter goes for the pick, the strip, gets neither. Green, all the way down to the one. Davis follows with a touchdown. The Chiefs lead is down to 31-28. Play action, Elway, Shannon Sharp, with just over 3 minutes to go. 35-31 Denver. Fourth down, last gasp Chiefs. Gannon, sack, Alfred Williams. The Broncos have hardly been tested this year. They were today. They win after coming from 10 back, 35-31.
This ranks up there close because we were down by 10, but I think that this was just more exciting because it's been such a long time that we've been in a game like this to where it seems like it was back and forth all day. So it was actually fun. It felt like the old days.
We hung in there. It wasn't pretty. You know, normally we don't turn the football, you know, over like we did down there. And, you know, we're disappointed when we come away with 3 points. There's a couple times we came away with absolutely nothing. And when you play a good football team, usually it comes back to haunt you. But we stepped up and made touchdowns when we had to make them, and our defense stepped up at the end of the game, and really a credit to everybody in that uniform today.
Here is the history established today by the Denver Broncos. Their 18 straight wins dating back to December last year. Ties, the 89-90 49ers, the 72-73 Dolphins, the 41-42 Bears, and there's that 33-34 Chicago club. 18 and counting. Next week at the Giants, 2 weeks from now, Broncos on Monday night in Miami. No one will be interested in that game, will they?
This halftime report is presented by Mercedes-Benz.
The wild AFC East, and what a wild finish to the Jets Seahawks. The Dolphins try to go to 9-4, the fastest 3 minutes coming up.
Who's that?
Me, Michael. Peter Pan. Do you remember when you were 8 and we went flying?
Oh, yeah.
Well, let's fly again.
But I can't fly anymore.
Well, of course you can fly. It's never too late to fly.
Like the body, the eye can't smell, and the nose can't hear. Running backs can't run if linemen don't interfere. Like the body, the mouth can't see, and the ear can't speak. Quarterbacks can't survive without receivers like their feet. We are a body, no jealousy. As a team, we can get home. Believe me, the eye can't do it alone.
I couldn't have been on the cover of ESPN, the magazine, if it wasn't for Chris Carter. He's taught me a lot. He's looked out for me. Been like a big brother to me. Isn't that right, Chris?
All we have to do is tighten this last bolt, and Randy's rocket will be ready to race. Who's the Soapbox Derby King? Who's the Soapbox Derby King?
Welcome back to the Mercedes-Benz Halftime Report with your host, Chris Berman.
Welcome back, everybody. 27-0, the Vikings at the half. Yardage in the first half, 341-14. Yowza. Well, the day began, especially in the AFC, where eight teams in that conference began the day over 500, 7-5 or better. Four of them reside in the AFC East. The Jets were one of them. They're division leaders, co-leaders with Miami at 8-4. They're hosting Seattle. And after a week of debating what we could do and what should be done, the last thing the NFL needed was another game in which certain aspects would be questioned about officiating. Here we go, the fastest 3 minutes. Vinny Testaverde with the Jets trailing 31-19. Vinny threw for over 400 yards. Touchdown Keyshawn Johnson. Jets within 5, 31-26. Fourth and goal. Testaverde calls his own number. Is he in? Took a while to decide. You decide. The 5-yard run that looked like 4.5 yards. Dennis Erickson can't believe it. But the Jets get the touchdown, and they win it 32-31. Meanwhile, Dolphins at the Raiders. Donald Hollis. The half-yard interception returned by Zach Thomas. 10-0 Miami. Hollis. This is about a 10-yard interception return for Robert Jones. Two picks, Miami win 27-17. What a great showdown next Sunday night on ESPN. Jets at Dolphins. Drew Bledsoe, Patriots at Steelers. Terry Glenn behind the defense, 86 yards. Good, go all the way. The Patriots continue to win 23-9 in Pittsburgh. Pats win their eighth. Pittsburgh falls to 7-6. Doug Flutie in the Bills. Little slant to Eric Mould, and the young receiver does the rest. Shakes. Rattle, and then roll. Touchdown. Flutie with 300 yard game, 33-20 the Bills. Cowboys at the Saints. The Saints held the Cowboys to 8 yards rushing. That's a franchise low. Meanwhile, Kerry Collins, Andre Hastings, 89 yards. Saints upset the Cowboys 22-3 impressively. The well-rested Tim Biancabatuca scores from 10 yards out. Carolina come from way back to tie San Francisco 28 all. Overtime. Panthers win the flip. Berline loses the ball. Chris Dolman falls on it. Steve Young a run. Wade Ritchie a field goal. 31-28. The Niners escape. The Colts led the Falcons 14-0 and then 21-7. But little trickery. Jamal Anderson. Back to Chris Chandler to Tony Martin on the flea flicker. Second quarter. Last play of the half. Chandler ties the game with a 3-yard run. Jamal Anderson, 122 yards on 30 carries. Falcons. Wow, they're 11-2, win it 28-21. Lions at the Jaguars. Mark Brunell, severely sprained ankle. They will know more tomorrow, at least x-rays for a break, negative. But Jamie Martin from Weber State looked great. Two first-half touchdown passes. This to Keenan McCardell. Fred Taylor, 183 yards. This touchdown, Jags win 37-22. They're 10-3. Ravens at the Oilers. Eddie George. Touchdown, 10-0 Oilers. The Oilers lead down to 16-14 in the final minute. Look at this. Samari Roll tips. Steve Jackson picks. Oilers win it at home, barely 16-14. Chargers at Skins. Brian Mitchell, he's such a weapon. Fields the kick in his own end zone, 1 yard deep. Let's get him go. Cut, go, all the way. Dragging the Chargers. Lyle Spencer, the last 15-yard. Skins win 24-20. Charles says, get out of my way. Giants leading in Arizona 20-17. Fourth and three. Cards down by six. Jake Plummer broken up. And the Cards have lost to the Giants both times this year, 23-19. Your final. Monday Night Countdown. It's Mike Tirico and the gang at 6:30 tomorrow here on ESPN. Get you set for Green Bay at Tampa Bay. Green Bay wins, they will get into playoffs. Tampa wins, they're tied with Arizona and New Orleans for the wild card spot. ABC starting with the last 8 o'clock Eastern is the kickoff. BCS final standings in the bowl matchup came out today. And by virtue, Miami's win over UCLA and Kansas State upset loss at the hands of Texas A&M. The national championship game, the Tostitas Fiesta Bowl on ABC, January 4th, Tennessee against Florida State. FedEx Orange Bowl in Florida against Syracuse on the 2nd. New Year's Day, the Nokia Sugar Bowl, Ohio State against Texas A&M. UCLA against Wisconsin and the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T. Those four games on ABC for Kansas State. They lose one game and they're out of all the big bowls. They're playing Purdue in the Alamo Bowl. Wow, the wrong time to lose for sure. Well, SportsCenter will come up after the game with Dan and Kenny, and then after that will be the re-air of Prime Time of the Day of Wild Football. And I'll tell you what, Minnesota goes for the jugular, don't they? One of two TD passes for Randall Cunningham. 27-0 Vikings at the half. Back to Minnesota.
Now, Mr. Wells, we're going to monitor your thoughts. Listen carefully. Your boss wants to have a talk with you. You're being audited. It's 110 degrees in rush hour traffic. You're stuck in a used car. Mr. Wells, a used car. Mr. Wells, are you paying attention?
This halftime report is presented by Mercedes-Benz.
Behind an enormous first half from Randall Cunningham, 275 yards and three touchdowns, the Vikings are up 27-0. Back with the second half in a moment.
We got everything on everyone's wish list.
What are you doing?
That TV is for your parents. What? That VCR is for our nephews. Will you stop it? That mini system is for your brother. These are gifts.
Not until December 25th, they're not.
We've got all the games on your Wiz list. Sony PlayStation, Nintendo 64, now $129 each, only at the Wiz.
I say we keep everything.
Cool.
What's on your Wiz list?
The more challenging the path, the more rewarding the life. That's the real spirit of a man. The Johnny Walker Collection, sportswear and accessories.
Details. 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 High-definition television is coming. Panasonic lets you experience it now. It's the most revolutionary idea since color. Panasonic, just slightly ahead of our time.
I'm John Randall, the Minnesota Vikings. Here, young people are learning to climb, not just physically, but academically, through this unique United Way supported program. Working together, we're solving today's problems through the United Way. The NFL, the United Way, and you, the power of teamwork.
Welcome back to Minneapolis for Sunday Night Football. Mike Patrick, Joe Theismann, Paul McGuire, Solomon Wilcots, and the Vikings making a shambles of the Bears, 27-0 at the half.
Randy Moss has had quite a night already. Seven receptions, 72 yards. You see him with only a 10-yard average, half of what he normally does. But the thing about him is he's just, you try and approach him, you say to yourself, all right, we want to try and get up on you. We want to be able to press you. Well, they haven't been able to do that. They just have not been able to stop him, whether they press him. If you play him off and let him run into the secondary, he's going to get his average at 22.
Well, a week ago against Dallas, 51, 56, and 56 were his touchdown catches. Only one other player in the history of this league ever did that, the great Raymond Berry. Back in 1960, three catches of more than 50 yards for touchdown. Berger to kick to Milburn, again drives him into the end zone. And the Bears will start from the 20. Let's go to Solomon Wilcott. Solomon.
Thanks, Mike. At halftime, I talked to Chicago Bears head coach Dave Wannstedt. He said that his team's inability to run the football has just been devastating. They cannot slow down the Vikings' pass rush. He says that he really wants to play more aggressive on Randy Moss. But where I'm standing, they're giving a little too much of attention to Randy Moss. It's allowing all the other receivers to get open. Andrew Glover caught the big pass down the middle late in the first half. All the other guys are getting open because they're paying too much attention to Randy Moss, Mike.
I think that's what that offense does, Solomon. It just forces you to do things you may not want to do and leave somebody open. And everybody picks up the slack. Stenstrom, the quick out, complete to Ingram. That's a gain of 10 yards. They had gained 14 in the entire first half. We always talk about Minnesota's offense. How about the defense limiting a team to 14 yards in two quarters of football? While they gained 341, the Bears did not convert a third down and had the ball only for 9 minutes and 59 seconds.
Dave Wong said, walk in yesterday, you know, we played really well here.
They have, previously.
Yeah.
Flags are down. Edgar Bennett is two at the line of scrimmage. Jerry Ball, the nose man, led the charge. And offsides against the Vikings.
Offside, defense, number 96, lined up in the neutral zone. 5 yards, first down.
Okay, when Jerry Ball lines up in a neutral
5 yards, first down.
Okay, when Jerry Ball lines up in a neutral zone, there's a lot of meat in a neutral zone. Yeah, there's Jerry Ball. I mean, his head, look at him. His head is over the center's head.
Trying to get as close as he possibly can.
I agree with you, Joe. You know, you're talking about Chicago on first down, throw the football. These guys are all bunched in on first down.
The Bears have yet to cross their own 36-yard line in this game. Play action, sends from under pressure. Throws on the run to the sideline. Ingram, did he get the feet in bounds? The officials checking with each other.
Sure he did. He made a heck of a catch and a heck of a move there as well. Stenstrom does a nice job of getting the ball up in the air, but Bobby Ingram does a terrific job on Corey Fuller of selling the up route. He's selling him. I'm going. No, I'm not. Now watch him get to the sidelines, much like we saw Randy Moss do. Freeze, make the catch, bring it into possession. Nice play.
Ingram has more than doubled his yardage total of any year of his career. He has a shot at 1,000 this year. Really breakout season for him. Stenstrom airs this one out for Ingram. Got it inside the 5. Touchdown. 47 yards, and he beat Jimmy Hitchcock.
It's amazing. Jimmy Hitchcock, as soon as he sees the play on Hitchcock, and when he does, Hitchcock turns around and, like, offensive pass interference. This is a sensational throw. Bobby Ingram, watch this. Hitchcock, 37, takes the inside move, and Ingram just beats him to the corner.
Yeah, you're right. I think Jimmy Hitchcock said, hey, look, he pushed off a little bit, but it's more incidental contact. Good protection that time. Stenstrom does a nice job of putting this ball up in the air and letting Bobby Ingram go get it.
One of Steve Stenstrom's strengths is throwing the deep ball. The Bears wait until the third quarter to get on the board for the first time.
Guess what? Guess what? Susie Fetterman got sick, so I don't have to be the dumb dinosaur. I get to be the peacock.
Great. Peacock.
Want to get away? Southwest has your ticket to freedom. For only $99 or less, you can fly coast to coast when you purchase by December 16th.
You are now free to move about the country.
Mark, if you're at the airport before my 8 o'clock flight, maybe we can talk. Otherwise, foot over.
Come on! Now!
Didn't get an AC Delco battery? They last up to 30% longer.
Barry!
AC Delco. If you're not asking for it, you're asking for it.
It's a little chilling, isn't it, Steve?
Oh, sorry. What am I thinking? How's that?
Yeah, thank you.
Better? Yeah.
Good. We were cold.
Check.
The only thing more important than your favorite receiver is your favorite card. Visa, official card of the NFL.
You look great tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's everywhere you want to be.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of the telecast or any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
We are told VWO stands for Viking World Order, which rules right now everywhere but in Denver, Colorado.
Yeah, you got Governor Boddy here taking it over.
80 yards in three plays. Homer. Took it back across the 20.
As we started to talk about earlier, Randy Moss presents you with some problems. How do you want to approach them? Do you want to press them? Well, I think that's what the Bears would like to try to do, get Walt Harris up in his face. If you don't, you got a problem. Here he does. Now it's the contact, and he still has the athletic ability to get up in the air and make a play. And that is such a true sign. He is every ex-secondary player's nightmare.
He makes defensive backs play scared. When they have pressed him, he's caught two out of the three. When they haven't, he's caught five out of five. Cunningham with plenty of time throws wide of Hatch at that time. Cousin, who has done a nice coverage job out there. Let's go to Solomon Wilcott. Solomon.
Yeah, Mike, despite the injuries to Jake Reed, Chris Carter, and Robert Smith at halftime, Dennis Green told me that he's really pleased how Randy Moss has answered the bell with two first-half touchdowns. He said that he wants to try to deliver a kill shot and keep the Bears out of the game. He wants a big play and a touchdown right here in the third quarter after the touchdown by the Bears, Bobby Engram, on their first possession. I'm sure he wants his team to take this one in for a touchdown right here.
Solomon, that was probably one thing he was actually pretty happy to see, because it was get his offense fired up again in the third quarter.
Offense. 5 yards, second down.
Stussy, the Pro Bowl left tackle who went to Hawaii for the first time a year ago and was named as a starter in that game. Dennis Green, when he drafted Randy Moss, when he was able to talk the organization into it, really rolled the dice. The old ownership was still in place. His future was in doubt. And if Moss had come in and gotten in trouble, as some teams suspected, that's why they passed on him, Dennis Green's future could have been decided immediately. But as it is, it has been a brilliant choice on his part. Cunningham just throws it across the sideline, chased by Brian Robinson.
That really just shows you how complete Randall has come as a quarterback. He's been very patient and doesn't take off and run at a heartbeat anymore. This time he's forced out of the pocket, knows the rules, understands once he gets outside that tackle box, get it near the first down marker. He's got the line of scrimmage. He's got himself just an incompletion. Come back to hunt another day.
The highest rated quarterback in the NFL. Evans and Palmer are the backs on third and long. Cunningham with a half roll.
Moss open. And that'll be interference. The ball was underthrown, and Marty Carter ran right over Moss. It'll be a gain of 45 yards. If Cunningham can somehow get five more yards on that, it's a touchdown.
I'll tell you what happens. He beats the jam. Walt Harris is going to try to jam at the line of scrimmage because he knows he has Marty Carter deep. Now watch this. First of all, he beats Walt Harris. Harris releases him. Watch what Carter does. Carter just lets him go by him instead of being on Randy Moss. And now that you're going to do, the only thing you can do is stop him from catching the footballs, hit him.
That's what happens when Randall Cunningham gets outside. Now watch his footwork. This is really where you win as a receiver. So very difficult to teach. You win at the line of scrimmage. That's where routes are won.
First down Vikings. Leroy Horde. Dragging tacklers with him inside the 35.
It was interesting talking to the Viking quarterbacks, Brad Johnson, Randall Cunningham, and also the players. They have never seen anybody throw the ball so far that Randy Moss can't get to it. He's never been overthrown.
If Cunningham can't overthrow you, I don't know if there's anybody out there who can.
Brad Johnson.
Was Brad Johnson, who's just a terrific guy, and I feel so badly for his injuries this year. But he's getting healthy, and he should be there by the time the playoffs start. Cunningham with a pump fake.
Moss. Got it. Touchdown. Holy cow.
It's not fair. It is not fair. You picked a better guy than I did on your team. That's all there is to it. Walt Harris, they audibleize at the line of scrimmage. They turn this into just a flex. Little stutter, quick post and go. Now he gets on the outside of Walt Harris. Looking back, he takes one little peek back, and the ball is floated up past him. It was that second look back that caused the problem. There he is again. Quick post, throw it up top. Randy goes and gets it.
Eight catches, 106 yards, and three touchdowns. 14 touchdown grabs on the year. He leads the NFL. I said he was going to be the rookie of the year when he was drafted. Now I say if he's not in the Pro Bowl, it's a crime. 34-7, Vikings.
The Sporty Saturn SC1. They look great, they handle great, they feel great, and they're going fast at
Saturn of Route 23, Saturn of Ramsey.
Lease the 99 Saturn SC1 complete with air conditioning, airbags, and automatic transmission for only $189 a month at New Jersey's largest Saturn retailer.
Saturn of Route 23, Saturn of Ramsey.
You deserve something great. The Saturn SC1 for only $189 a month at
Saturn of Route 23, Saturn of Ramsey.
AHI Institute offers a course that will enable you to do inspections on your own or for a full-service home inspection company. Our knowledgeable instructors offer hands-on teaching on full-scale models of all major systems. The AHI Institute is fully accredited by the American Society of Home Inspectors. Once you have successfully completed AHI's course, you will receive a certificate and also be guaranteed to pass the ASHI exam. For more information, call AHI at 973-423-9315 and take advantage of this exciting opportunity.
You know how it feels when you're involved in an accident, the stress and confusion of what to do, like calling your insurance, getting towed, the repairs, and you'll need a rental car. It's enough to make your head spin. But don't worry. Mazzaro and Son Auto Body does it all. They'll tow your car, contact your insurance, rent you a car, and attend to any repairs. For 50 years, Mazzaro and Son has been the customer's choice by returning your car in A1 condition as quickly as possible. Remember, it's your choice. Choose Mazzaro and Son.
Sunday Night Football is brought to you by AC Delco. If you're not asking for it, you're asking for it. By Visa, the preferred card of the NFL. It's everywhere you want to be. By AT&T, it's all within your reach. And by Saturn, a different kind of company, a different kind of car. The explosive offense of the Minnesota Vikings blowing away the Chicago Bears. From the 5, Milburn, cut down across the 25. Randy Moss now has another rookie record, 14 touchdown catches after his first 13 career games. Look how far back you have to find guys who did this before in the early days of the NFL's passing game.
And that's when you really had to be pinned to the ground. Not just knocked down, you had to be pinned down. The guys could get up and run.
You notice now he's jacking up his average. He went from 10 to 13. He's trying to get back to 21.
Edgar Bennett is the single setback for Stenstrom, who throws the out to Conway, and he did not get both feet down.
When you take a look at that last play by the Vikings, you're going to see two things. You're going to see two audibles called. One by Randall Cunningham. You see him punch his fist into his hand. That's an audible to the wide receivers. Now watch Jeff Christie, the center. He's looking around. He's looking at the blocking up front. He's signaling to his linemen, this is what you want. It's a quick post, and it's a go, and Randall puts it up. Walt Harris makes a critical mistake. He looked back twice and still couldn't find the ball.
Here comes the blitz. Bennett got it to the outside and reaches the 30-yard line.
We just go back to Randy Moss for 1 second. We had Marty Carter in the room talking to him about this guy. said, you know how fast he is and everything. He says, the only one way that I know of, or I think, that you could ever overthrow him is if he loses the ball in the lights. That was one of the great lines. He said, if he loses it in the lights, that would be the only way you could overthrow him.
Well, he certainly has served notice that it's going to be difficult, even if you want to try and jam him, to try and shut him down.
I don't know if there are any answers upstairs either, Walt. Denstrom unloads for Conway. Contact and a flag. Conway run into by Jimmy Hitchcock.
Jimmy Hitchcock is what he is saying is, I'm turning and I'm looking for the ball. You got to understand, you know, about pass interference, folks. When that ball is up in the air, that is anybody's ball.
Pass interference, number 37, first down.
The defense has as much right to the ball as the offense. Now, this ball is up in the air. Denstrom just hangs it. Curtis Conway on Jimmy Hitchcock, 80. Now, watch 37. Forget about 80. Just look at 37. Does he pass interference? I'm telling you, he turns and he looks back at the ball. He's just running at the ball right here.
No, Paul.
Yes, Joe.
No, he's running for the ball, but Conway had to slow down and try and make a play, and Hitchcock runs into him.
Close call, but I'll go with Joe on this one. Remember, I get the tiebreaker. Ty Halleck, the fullback, breaks the tackle. Halleck down to the 12-yard line.
Jimmy Hitchcock just got absolutely buried by Big Cat Williams blocking downfield for Ty Halleck.
Remember the old sucker play? Watch Jerry Ball. This is what they call a sucker play. Watch 96. They just let him across the line of scrimmage and it just edge him down a little bit. You don't have to really block him.
Watch Big Cat come in from the right side. Boom! Awful.
Bennett, the deep man in the eye. Denstrom under a blitz, and McDaniel got it. Ed McDaniel says, if I see an opening, brother, I go. And he went.
One play action pass too many, Joseph.
Well, you know, you got to get your backs to pick up the backers on play action pass. That's what is so critical. It's the back's job to help the quarterback out a little bit. Here comes the play action fake. You got Edgar Bennett. He's standing. I don't know who he's trying to block. It looked to me like McDaniel went right by him. I don't know who he thinks is going to get him.
He's getting out of the pattern.
Yeah. It's safe.
Third and 19. Draw play to Bennett. Edgar Bennett with running room down to the 10-yard line.
Dave Weinstadt's going to go for it. What's the sense of kicking a field goal? Why kick it on third down? I know that. I like the fact he's going for it on third down. Don't you? It's a bizarre game.
I love it. Another blitz. Stinson out in the flat and bobbled two or three times by Mays.
Well, you're not beating these guys up, but you know, he said Alonzo Mays is just not there. You talk about a guy, Joe, fighting a ball. Just fight the football. Just catch it.
Well, he's a rookie, missed a lot of camp, hasn't really been a very efficient pass blocker. Here's one out in the flat. Now you're right, Paul. He's just trying to figure out any way he can to hold on to it.
Nice throw by Stenstrom in rhythm, right on the money.
Fourth down? I like the fact.
I like it when they go for it on fourth down.
I like going for it on third, too. I think it's good.
The crowd comes to its feet. Stenstrom with a fade, and it's incomplete. Covered well by Hitchcock. Trying for Chris Penn. He couldn't get close. There's a timeout on the field. The Bears come up empty again.
AT&T 00info, how can I help you?
I need the phone number of Petey's Dog Grooming. Or is it Punky's? I'm not exactly sure the name.
Now you can get information even if you don't have all the information. AT&T customers, dial 00. You don't need the exact name.
Found it. Pinky's dog grooming.
Dial 00 for any number, anywhere. We'll even connect you to your number for free.
Oh, oh, it's magic. You know.
That last egg's looking real good. If you have a High Life light, maybe you will have room for just one more. See there? When you live the High Life, you can live it both ways.
Arriving at last from Saturn, the world's first three-door coupe. Why didn't anyone think of this before?
Head and Shoulders makes me worry less. I used to kind of be self-conscious about playing with my hair because if I was wearing black, then I would end up with flakes on my shoulders. Black's my favorite color to wear, so it could be a beauty secret. Head and Shoulders changes dandruff problems into beautiful hair.
It's my job to keep the plexiglass clean. In fact, I want it so clean you don't even know it's there. Ah! 10 minutes, he's back. He'll be fine. He'll walk it off. Fly away.
They do love the new governor, Jesse, formerly the body Ventura, now Jesse the brain Ventura. And yes, he could win a steel cage match against any other governor. We've got our own tag team with Chris and the rest of the gang. Vikings take over deep in their own territory. Cunningham airs another one out. Moss intercepted by Harris.
It was underthrown. It was underthrown. That's unbelievable. Randall Cunningham got that ball out as quickly as he possibly could, and Randy Moss had to try and come back and wait for it. He gets on top. Watch it. This is just a flat go. Randy Moss. Now, Randy's got him beat. Randy is running away from him. The ball winds up being short. Walt Harris makes the play on it.
Well, what a nice adjustment by Walt Harris. So this time he didn't stop running like he did on the touchdown. He just moved inside and made the interception. I was going to say that's the spark they need, but
you know, can't overthrow him. You cannot overthrow him.
Unless he loses it in your life.
Walt checking in to see how that one registered upstairs. Stenstrom. Picked off right in the hands of Dixon Edwards.
I'll tell you, that one just scared Dixon Edwards.
Dixon Edwards is standing there, and he's number 59.
And when I've been watching these three linebackers move all night. Dixon Edwards is 59, right on the left. Let's look at this. He knocks off Curtis Conway, and that's who the ball was supposed to be thrown to, and then it hits him right in the mouth.
Edwards, the only member of the Vikings to play in a Super Bowl. He has three rings from the Dallas Cowboys. Ty Hallett, a couple and nothing more after the Bears 43.
Trying to get that clock moving.
Chris Carter is now in street clothes.
A strained right calf very early in the ball game. And Carter's streak of 111 games with a catch is going to come to an end.
Nice suit.
Oh, he's sharp on and off the field. They have done all this damage without three of their star offensive players tonight. Here comes the blitz. Centrum with a screen to Bennett. Bennett run out of bounds very close to a first down. Depends on the mark. They'll put it down in midfield. That appears to be short. Kaylee Wong, the rookie out of Stanford, was in on the tackle.
Boy, Kaylee Wong makes a sensational play. If they don't make this first down, it's because of him. Number 52 is Wong. He reads the screen. They have a blitz on. He's the guy that's going to have to stay back. Number 52, look, he gets in the middle of the field, sees the screen with Bennett, and watch him close. That's outstanding speed. Now he goes out. Looks right, sees the screen. Now he's the guy that's going to make the play.
fourth and a yard, the Bears will go. The Vikings had 12 men on the field trying to get somebody off, and it looks like they did. And Stenstrom throws the sideline for Ingram. Nice hit, Bobby Ingram. Here's a guy who had been labeled as a possession receiver since the day he came into the NFL, and he says he didn't like that. He doesn't mind going over the middle, but he wants to be known as a big play guy, and he's doing it this year.
That was a big play he made on fourth down. He just goes up for the ball. He's up against Corey Fuller in press coverage. He gets by. Now he looks up. Now he's going to go up, and I'm going to go make a play on the ball. That's just pure determination.
I'll tell you, yesterday when you called him a possession receiver, he looked at you like, no, I'm not.
Well, that's what he was, and he knew it. He's changed the perception this year. The Bears showing some offense. Here's another blitz. The pass too strong for Alonzo Mays. McDaniel was out there. Excuse me, Dixon Edwards was out on the coverage in the flat.
That's two out of three plays that they've sent. Number 24, the strong safety, Robert Griffin.
This is a very aggressive defensive unit.
And I think Foch still ought to continue to send them. It's second down and long. You've only got yourself a, 27-point lead. Why not cut them loose and let them fly? That's how your guys are going to build their stats.
And that's what they do best. Denton with protection this time. Halleck underneath. Not much as Edwards is there again. ESPN Sunday Night Football continues next week with a huge battle in the AFC East. Vinny Testaverde and the Jets take on Dan Marino and the Miami Dolphins. Join Joe Theismann, Paul McGuire, and me right after primetime at 8:15 Eastern. ESPN and ABC, your exclusive networks for primetime NFL football. A huge game next week in Miami.
Miami plays very well on defense at home.
Another blitz. Draw play. Bennett. Edwards is right there, or McDaniel right there, had him around the ankle and dragged him down.
That time, McDaniel decided when he was going to close into the gap, he came under control. Instead of just coming recklessly through the hole, he comes under control. Watch number 58. He starts on the blitz, squares up, does a good job of hanging on to Edgar Bennett. And here's that fourth down again, Paul.
I think you're going to go for it again.
Yeah, I saw Jeff Jaeger out there practicing field goals at halftime, and I was wondering why.
They need points and punches. They need to reach the 14 for a first down, another blitz. Ingram underneath to the 10, to the 6. Bobby Ingram with another grab. Orlando Thomas had to make the catch, and tonight Ingram was 6. For 130 yards.
You know that Bobby Ingram scores here. If Alonzo Mays, number 85, the tight end, just blocks somebody, he's down in the secondary and has no idea what's going on. Watch Orlando Mays, number 85. Ingram catches the ball in the slant. It's a good throw, great catch. And on the right-hand side of your screen, you'll see 85. He's standing there. He hadn't hit a soul.
Edgar Bennett, big hole up the middle, touchdown. And this is the one question that people have about the Minnesota Vikings. Can this defense, if it's put under pressure, stand up? And I think the jury's still out.
Well, we talked about the offensive line having to do their job for the Bears. This is Todd Perry, number 75, their left guard. He does a terrific job on McDaniel. Creates a gigantic crater for Bennett to be able to hit into the end zone.
Point after by Jaeger is good. And Edgar Bennett, with only his second in place of the injured Curtis Enos, the Bears with their second score.
World Video in Little Ferry, the adult video emporium, offers everything from erotic to exotic entertainment. Unlike other video stores, all the videos in our vast collection can be rented or purchased at fantastic prices. We've got everything from bedroom toys to the hottest in adult CD-ROMs. We're open 7 days. So if you're 21 or older, come on down. We're located at 401 Main Street, just off of 46 East in Little Ferry.
$79.95.
What's that? Taxes I pay on my home?
$79.95 will get you a brand new Cepia from a room Kia Wayne.
You mean I can buy a new 98 Cepia with dual airbags and a 3-year warranty for only $79.95?
Yes, only $79.95 at a room Kia Wayne. Or lease a Cepia for just $99 a month for 36 months.
You are kidding. I could be driving a new Cepia for only $99 a month? That's less than my phone bill.
And Maroon Kia has a huge selection in stock.
Where is Maroon Kia?
Come to Maroon Kia on the Hamburg Turnpike in Wayne.
World Video in Little Ferry, the adult video emporium, offers everything from erotic to exotic entertainment. Unlike other video stores, all the videos in our vast collection can be rented or purchased at fantastic prices. We've got everything from bedroom toys to the hottest in adult CD-ROMs. We're open 7 days, so if you're 21 or older, come on down. We're located at 401 Main Street, just off of 46 East in Little Ferry.
Vikings 34-14. They say the excitement around here has brought back some of the old fans. Taking a scan of the audience, maybe they went back just a little too far. Vikings get it out across the 20. They'll have a first down. And the fans, decorated or not, are loving every second of it.
The new Saturn coupe has been conveniently redesigned, so it's easier for your friends to get in. The world's first three-door coupe from Saturn. Why didn't anyone think of this before?
Reborn on ESPN2, Friday Night Fights. This week, live from the Blue Horizon, Canizales takes on DeJesus. Plus, Archie Moore, a retrospective. Friday Night Fights, Friday at 8 on ESPN2.
Last week, we got to see the undefeated Denver. It's hard, easy
guys.
For me to say. Denver Broncos, best team in the AFC. Tonight, the Minnesota Vikings, the best team in the NFC.
Well, you know, I'm looking at both of these teams from a defensive standpoint. I think both defenses are a little bit questionable.
Well, I think Denver's defense right now is a bit more solid, but offensively, they're very comparable. Have big play receivers, have an important tight end as a part of it. Both running backs are able to make big plays, Terrell Davis, and when Robert Smith is healthy, he's a guy who can break it off and take it down. You look at the way these offenses are set up, they're set up to be able to make big plays, and I think they have to.
Leroy Horde back at running back. It's up to the 24. Let's check in with Solomon Wilcots and have him talk about the special teams.
You know, Mike, you talk about the offensive defense for the Broncos and the Vikings. What about the special teams? Both teams have two of the best kickers in the National Football League. The Broncos have Jason Elam. He had been perfect in field goals up until he had a kick blocked today against Kansas City, but he still has the longest kick in the history of the National Football League, 63-yarder earlier this season. And, of course, Gary Anderson, he remains perfect, and he has the most field goals of any kicker in the National Football League. Mike?
All right, Solomon, I'm glad you guys can say Denver. Apparently, I can't. Leroy Horde on the draw to the 36.
Oh, Randall McDaniel, Jeff Christie. This was run right up the middle and outstanding blocking. Here we go. Just take a look at Randall McDaniel and Christie. Look at the blocks right here.
Randall McDaniel goes down. Christie comes back out. He gets on the linebacker. That is beautiful. That's the way you draw it up. Thanks for the circle, Joe. Thank you for the
circle. I do it for you.
Leroy Horde is not the guy who's going to give you a 75-yard touchdown run, but he will get you every inch he can. Horde again off the right side. Picks up a couple up to the 38-yard line.
Well, the Vikings on offense now are seeing another element of their game. Can they be a patient offense? Can they pound the ball out, pick up 5, 6, 7 yards? Brian Belichick, this is something, you know, his nature is to go down the field. He's tutelage under Bill Walsh and loves to put the ball down. Yeah, tutelage, I can say that.
Randall Cunningham in two games against the Chicago Bears has 8 touchdown passes. He's not done yet. Still have 2:57 to go in the third quarter. Flat, his tight end can't hold it. Greg DeLong got one hand on it. Covered well by Ricardo McDonald.
The Bears have really made their mind up defensively that what they want to do is they're going to rush 3 and 4 guys up front. They're going to drop 7 and 8 into coverage, hopefully not getting beat for the big plays. Of course, we know Randy Moss can just flat run. And I think that's the way that Dave Wannstedt can have any kind of success, is just trying to get those 4 guys in Randall's face somehow. If they're going to catch it, make the tackle.
Third and 8 for Minnesota. Cunningham throws on the run. Harris nearly had another interception in front of Moss. That time the Bears only rushed 3 and dropped 8. They had everybody covered.
They had everybody covered, and you're right. That rushing 3 is not going to get it. But here's Walt Harris on Moss. Now, he wants to jam him, which he does. Now, Moss gets away from him. He knows he's got help deep. But Walt Harris, all he's doing is looking at Cunningham. That ball should have been caught by the defense.
Berger on to punt for only the second time as Harris goes to the sideline. Berger's first punt was 44. Milburn waits back at the 15. Just got it out of there. And Milburn with a fair catch. A punt of 44 and no return. Coming up next, SportsCenter, Dan Patrick and Kenny Mayne. They'll bring you up to date on everything. The Broncos in a squeaker today. The bowl lineup from the BCS. Our conversation, Joe Theismann talking with Randy Moss. That's followed with NFL Primetime, Chris Berman, Tom Jackson, all the highlights of all the day's games.
Randy had an interesting view on the Heisman last year as well, which will be coming up next week here on ESPN. Something else I didn't win.
Honestly,
I really didn't.
That's the only thing you didn't win.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, but it changed your name.
That's true. Changed the pronunciation of my name.
Bennett. What do you think Dave Wannstedt would have given to get off to this offensive start in the first half? It would have fit in with what he had planned, but it just didn't happen.
I think he would have wanted to, except that the Vikings really just stole it away from him. They came out and hit the big ones early and got the momentum behind him, got the crowd involved. And now it's fought back to a more even keel for his team, but they're still down 20 points.
Second and 7. Olin Krutz checks back in at center for Chicago. Stenstrom dumps it off to Halleck, and Halleck cut down in his tracks by Fuller at 22.
Boy, was that a nice play by Corey Fuller. You know, here's number 27. He just releases Ingram on the outside. He sees him throw the ball to Ty Halleck. And just watch this. Watch the play by Fuller, number 27. Bang, the ball is there. He just releases, comes up, and makes the tackle. And that's the one thing you got to do is be sure of the tackle.
Well, you know, the other thing, too, is if your corners, like the way Minnesota plays theirs up close, you have to trust that those safeties are going to protect you behind them. This defense now is playing very well in a coordinated fashion.
Third and 5. Blitz, they get rid of it to Halleck, and Ed McDaniel wraps him up. Just got back to the line of scrimmage. In 95, McDaniel had as good a year as a linebacker has had in the last 10 in the NFL on the outside. Then he blew up a knee, and really, this is the first year he's been healthy since.
Well, you know, it's tough to put a linebacker on a really good back, a fast back. But when you got him on Ty Halleck, it's a mismatch in his favor.
Horan, the oldest punter down in the history of the NFL, hangs one up. Palmer with a fair catch. Peyton Manning, Ryan Leaf, and Andre Wadsworth were the consensus top three in the draft. Here's what happened after that.
Charles Woodson, Curtis Enos, Grant Wistrom, Kyle Turley, Greg Ellis, Brent Taylor, Dwayne Stark, Trey Thomas, Keith Brooking, Takeo Spikes, Anthony Simmons, Kevin Dyson, Brian Simmons, Robert Edwards,
Bonnie Holliday, Terry Fair.
All those players picked before Randy Moss.
The only thing you didn't hear was a thank you from Dennis Green.
Cunningham with a screen to Leroy Horde. Couple of nice blocks in front. And Horde with a beautiful job of setting up the blocks all the way to the 45, a gain of 21. And they will let the clock run down to end the third quarter. The Vikings with the ball on another drive and in complete command of this game, going for their 12th win of the year. 34-14 Minnesota.
Mike Ditka for 1-800-COLLECT.
Hey, come on, ladies! Hey, give me that! Make believe I just insulted your mama. Or make believe I just traded you. Make believe I just called you collect without using 1-800-COLLECT.
Hey, but it's 10 cents a minute every evening with 1-800-COLLECT.
Stop, guys. I was only kidding. Stop.
1-800-COLLECT. 10 cents a minute every evening all week long.
Let's get going.
Okay, there is no time to lose. Subscribers are waiting. We have to send out these official ESPN the Magazine duffel bags ASAP. Right, buddy?
Right. Oh, ESPN the Magazine duffel bag. All right.
Subscribe now to ESPN the Magazine and get your sports the way it ought to be. Big and bold with unbelievable photos, honest interviews, previews and predictions, the teams to beat and the players to watch.
Ralph, I'm begging you, man.
Wally, help me. Believe we're giving these away for free?
Get 26 issues, a year's worth for just $1 an issue. That's 66% off the newsstand price. And with your paid subscription, you'll get your own ESPN the Magazine duffel bag. Absolutely free.
I wonder what lucky new subscriber is going to get this one, huh?
No subscriber is going to get that one unless you put it in a box.
Call now, 1-800-540-1155.
It's just around the corner. I don't know about you, but my shopping's done. Ha-ha.
Mine is. It's my wife did it.
That was
and did a
same
great job of doing it, too.
I'm not giving anybody anything.
I wonder if his Christmas shopping's done. I wonder if he's alive.
He's tough to buy for.
He's got a bottle in each hand.
34-14, Vikings on top of the Bears. 15 minutes to go from the Metrodome. Ford, the single setback. He'll get the ball and pick up four. Of course, everybody is an expert now with Randy Moss having all this success saying, why didn't our team take Randy Moss when they had a shot? The same reason Dave Wannstedt and Mark Hatley, the personnel boss for the Chicago Bears, did not take him. Because of Lawrence Phillips and other situations, people were scared to death of a public eyesore.
Yeah, but also I think in the case of the Bears, they had a bigger need at running back than they did in wide receiver.
But it was understandable, and I think even Randy Moss would acknowledge that people were just scared off because of what was reported in his background. And I think that was a legitimate concern for all those teams.
Well, I like talking to Dennis Green about it. He said, I said, was it unanimous?
He said it was by Tuesday, because he was the unanimous guy. But the thing that he did is he called Randy Moss on the phone. He said, we're going to take you, and because you dropped that far down in the draft, it's going to cost you about $4 million. But you come with us, we'll make you the third receiver, not much pressure on you, and you'll make it up. Cunningham is a wide receiver.
Randall Cunningham flanks out. Palmer is the quarterback in the shotgun. Palmer now runs to the right, and he'll keep it. Palmer still on his feet, 25-23.
You know, that's another thing I really like about Brian Billick as an offensive coordinator. He's creative, he's imaginative, and you know what a play like that does? When you put that in on a Wednesday, it gets everybody excited in a game, and it says, hey, I can't wait for the coach to call that. Well, and this is keeping everybody involved.
Well, look at Palmer at Alabama. He ran this mostly on the goal line, and David, I mean, if you have a guy that knows how to run it, why not put him in? I just like the fact they take Randall Cunningham and take him way out. Now look at Moss. On Harris, he leaves Harris, goes on to Carter. I like that.
Cunningham looking downfield, throws, and nobody home, just got rid of it. Brian Robinson has had a good ball game, the second-year defensive lineman from Fresno State.
You know, we're
putting on the pressure.
We're talking about the Denver Broncos and the Minnesota Vikings. When you see a play like that and a formation like that, if you're a playoff coach, you know, that's something you have to concern yourself with. We saw the Broncos throw the ball back to John Elway. That's something else you have to be concerned with. The more things that you have to prepare for, the less time you can spend on it.
And you're right. Practice can be boring. You put in a play like that, it gets everybody's interest.
Great.
Charles Evans on the draw. Nothing doing. Wrapped up and thrown down by Mike Wells, the free agent that they got from the Detroit Lions.
This Bear defensive line has continued to come off the ball. Mike Wells, number 97, really helped Jim Flanagan out a lot. Releases inside. They try and block him. Dixon can't quite get a hold on him as Christie tries to come out and seal. And he makes the play.
Wells, the free agent who has become the run stopper on this line and freed up Flanagan for a lot of one-on-one plays. Third and 14 for Randall Cunningham. Blitz coming. Cunningham unloads. Glover inside the 10. The rookie Tony Parrish had to make the tackle, but it's a gain of 19.
Well, and you got Theory, number 91, is in coverage. The zone blitzing. And look at John Theory. I mean, he was almost in the right position. Watch. He hits Glover at the line of scrimmage. Now watch. The ball is thrown behind. Perfect throw. Theory can't get outside.
Randall really throws this ball the only place he can. He would like to have let Andrew up the field a little bit more, but knows he won't get the completion if he does.
First and goal. Horde is back in. Moss the man in motion. Horde with a carry. Breaks a tackle. Touchdown! Carl Reeves missed the tackle. Leroy Horde with another hard, tough run. And the Vikings are pouring it on.
This is all Leroy Horde.
Really,
it's all Horde. It's all number 44. And I mean, guys are standing around trying to make some blocks, but watch what he does. Look at his feet. His legs never stop moving. Keeps his legs moving. He sees the hole back inside. People, if you're not going to block, get out of my way. Corey Stringer, 77, get out of the way. Get out of my way.
Got a lot of admiration for Leroy Horde. 69 yards rushing tonight, 63 yards receiving. A great job of filling in for Robert Smith.
One Happy Baby Lullaby CD, $14. Cashmere Cardigan for Wife, $129. Portable Stereo with Active Hyper Bass for in-laws, $160. Holiday shopping in your underwear, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Search Holiday at Excite.com for fast, easy internet shopping with MasterCard.
I find Melville's allegories captivating.
Not to mention the 18th century Calvinistic undercurrent.
Show the world your intelligence. Save up to $2,400 now on Tacoma option packages.
Beethoven's Piano Concerto Number 4.
Opus 58.
Classic Ludwig.
Extra value packages. Available on all Tacoma models.
Something's not quite right. There. Now that's a sandwich. And there's only one beer that can stand up to a man's meal. That's the High Life. That's Miller Time.
Hey, who's that?
She's here to meet with the big guys.
On a weekend? She must be a big client.
I think it's her life insurance agent.
Huh. Have you heard from the Quiet Company? Northwestern Mutual Life.
ESPN Sunday Night Football brought to you by MasterCard. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. By ToyotaCon, celebrating 20 years of incredible values. By Miller High Life. And by Northwestern Mutual Life. Have you heard from the Quiet Company? The Minnesota Vikings have scored 87 points in the last two games against Dallas and Chicago. Waits for Berger's kickoff. Put most of them in the end zone. This one a yard deep. Milburn will bring it out. And dives out to the 30-yard line.
Now, you want to know what Mitch Berger does after he kicks off?
Yeah, I do.
All right.
He goes to the sideline. And in his tennis shoe, he has a Snickers bar.
Oh, man.
And
energy.
Take a bite. I'm going to tell you what, you know, I like Snickers, but that thing has got to start to smell bad after a while. I mean, how long are you going to put
it? No, he's got it in a wrapper, though.
I don't care. It's in your shoe, man.
Hey, these games are long, especially when your offense is out. I mean, you got to remember, he doesn't kick very much. The offense is out there a lot.
Now, you were, there you go. We love our Snicker kicker. Now, you were a kicker. What'd you keep in your shoe?
My feet.
Good choice.
Thought so.
Draw play to Bennett, nothing doing, lost a yard.
They ran that draw play to keep those linebackers honest.
Well, they had to get to second and 11 so they could get into a passing situation. I mean, they're really running, I think, just to try and slow down the rush a little bit so that they can put the ball down the field. The Vikings will play a lot more cautious now.
Four-man rush. Stenstrom with time. Throws incomplete. Penn had it right in his chest and lost it. The NHL on the deuce this Tuesday at 8 Eastern when the Dominator, Buffalo Sabres goalie Dominic Hasek, heads to St. Louis to battle Chris Pronger and the Blues. All the action there begins at 8 Eastern.
And he is the Dominator.
You say so.
Well, he's in Buffalo. I'm in Buffalo. I'm the cast. He's terrific. He's the best goalie in
hockey.
Well, I was going to say the world. I was going to say the world.
World of hockey.
Third and long for Stenstrom. Blitz coming. Pump fake in the bomb. Conway way overthrown and intercepted by Orlando Thomas. But there is a flag down. And there is a reason it may have been way overthrown.
Ramos McDonald winds up grabbing Curtis Conway. It's a double move. McDonald really does everything he can to slow him down. That's what will be the penalty. It's going to be against number 34.
Illegal contact. Number 34. Defense. 5 yards. Automatic first down.
That's a good call by Matt Cavanaugh. They've had success going up the field. Here's the pump. Little out. Little up. He grabs him. Hangs on to him. Really just tried to slow him down a little bit and allowed the ball to be thrown up the field, and Orlando Thomas comes up with the pick, but it won't count.
And Dave Wonstead's got to be awfully proud of his offensive line in this second half because they have done a pretty good job. They haven't even gotten close to Stenstrom.
Especially when you know that the defense is just teeing off and coming.
Exactly. You know, the good part about it, they get first down. The worst part about that whole thing, they lose about 30 yards off the play because there's only holding.
Automatic first down at the 35. With a short set, goes to Conway. Curtis out to the 40-yard line for a gain of 5 where Dwayne Rudd brought him down.
Curtis Conway had hoped to be a bigger part of this Chicago offense. Only has two touchdown passes coming into tonight and just 38 catches. And I think a lot of that has to do with the instability that they've had at the quarterback position.
And Eric Kramer, of course, had to undergo shoulder surgery and arthroscopic knee surgery out for the year. They went with Moses Moreno the last game. Stenstrom again to the sideline. Conway can't hold this one. This is a team that does not have a lot of star quality to it. Their drafts have been very poor. It's one of the reasons the organization went out and got Mark Hatley to direct the pro personnel. And they are very satisfied with his situation now. They have not drafted a player who has represented them in the Pro Bowl since 91. The second longest streak in the NFL. The last Pro Bowl player they drafted was Mark Carrier. They got rid of him, and he's in Detroit.
And that's going to change for the Falcons this year because they're going to put more than one guy in the Pro Bowl, I guarantee you.
Absolutely. Ingram on the end around. Fuller. Beautifully defensed and takes him out of bounds.
And I tell you what, you got to love, you know, you always talk about your receivers. Curtis Conway gets an outstanding block, number 80, and he almost opened it up for Ingram to make the first down. They don't get his fourth down, and guess what, Joe?
They have to go for it, Paul.
Okay,
no question.
Down 41-14 with 9 minutes and 36 seconds to go. Coach Fazio over there trying to rally his troops. John Randall's been reasonably quiet in this ballgame. Called fourth and two, officially. Stenstrom wants to throw for it. Conway's got it. Conway fighting for extra yards down to the 47. There is not much of a passing tradition with the Chicago Bears. Conway in 95 and 96, the only receiver in their history with back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons.
Well, you know, that's on fourth down. They're throwing the ball, so they're not afraid of anything. And look at Conway. Nice. He just runs him off and he makes the catch. But I'll tell you, when I talk about the offensive line, watch Todd Perry, 75. Look at him on John Randall. He gets a double team, I understand it. But Todd Perry has been keeping John Randall at the line of scrimmage.
Done a nice job. Fabian Bones, number 82, comes in as a wide receiver. Stenstrom throws short to Chris Penn. Breaks a couple of tackles and picked up another 6 or 7 yards.
The results of what we see when he crosses our yellow first and 10 line, but the critical thing is that Minnesota is really just rushing four.
All right, now look at John Randall. He was inside. Now look at these guys. Valerio takes him on blocking him, number 58. I mean, that's just switching off. This offensive line is doing everything that Wanstead wanted him to do in the beginning of the game. They're doing it in the second half.
Mike, I think this is 6, maybe 7 inches short. Looking for redemption. Late in the season, a little redemption.
Woo! Wait a minute, Paul, he got one right.
Woo!
We've been doing this for 12 years.
You've got the yellow line. I mean, that'd take a genius to figure that out. We've got a yellow line for
you. I was almost ready to give him credit.
I really couldn't quite see it. Mike's board's in front of it over there.
If it wasn't for the ESPN first and 10 line, he'd have never got it.
So, all right, so I got aided by technology. It's more than the league is doing.
I'll tell you one thing about the Chicago Bears team. You talk about all the quality and stuff. These guys have not quit. This offense has been outstanding in the second half.
Stenstrom under pressure this time. Gets away. Dumps it to Bennett. 20. 15. Pushed out of bounds by McDaniel. Nice decision by Stenstrom. And it's a gain of 29.
Again, the Minnesota Vikings only choosing to rush four and drop seven back in the pocket. The Bears have done a nice job of creating an area for him to work in. He drops back, steps up, and knows exactly where the players are. He's very bright and knows what he wants to do with the ball.
We were wondering what happened to John Randall's spin move. Joe, here's one on Valerio. Look at this move. And Valerio, I'm going to tell you, what a great job he does to stay with him. He comes back and gets him and allows Stenstrom to step up in the pocket.
First and goal, Chicago. Draw play, Bennett. Runs into his own man, still gets down to the four.
I don't believe that you can judge the Minnesota Viking defense on what they tried to do against Dave Wannstedt's offense in this quarter. I think people are going to say, oh, wow, look how vulnerable they are. Look, they've got a 27-point lead, and Coach Fazio is just not going to show you a lot. He doesn't need to. And part of, you know, part of the guys are saying, geez, let's go after him. The coach says, let's just do what we have to win a football game.
Joe, it's an excellent point, and it's very difficult to get that sky high when you've got the game in hand. Bennett hit by Rudd.
Ouch.
Well, this is the play that you talked about back in the first half that Ed McDaniel told us about. If you see a hole, take it. Well, Rudd saw a hole, and he took it. Watch the 57. Perry pulls, and when he pulls, that hole is open. Watch the hole open up. He just follows right behind the guard, Perry, and makes the tackle in the backfield.
You don't have enough people up front to block and account for the defensive linemen and the linebackers if they shoot the gaps.
Third and goal from the 7. Four wide receivers in for Stenstrom. Half roll tip. He was trying to throw it for Wet Knight, and it was knocked away by Kaylee Wong.
Kaylee Wong does a good job. They always tell you, with action away, stay home. He gets up the field. He makes a nice play, gets his hands in the air, keeps his feet on the ground, doesn't try and jump or leap, gets a hand up and bats the ball down.
He's really got some quickness. 257 pounds.
And every one of those linebackers of theirs can run. That's really a big key to Minnesota defensively.
They're all quick, very athletic, with great speed. Even their down linemen can run. And the play clock running down, Stenstrom has to use a timeout with 6:02 left in the game.
It's the Maroon GM Superstore in Riverdale, where you'll find hundreds of new GM cars and trucks. At Maroon's GM Superstore, we'll beat any deal, whether you buy or lease any new Pontiac, Buick, or GMC truck.
Hi, I'm Ray Maroon. We'll pay off your present lease and put you on the road again with no money down.
Maroon GM Superstore, Route 23 and 287. Our service department is open nights and Saturdays. The Maroon GM Superstore at Routes 23 and 287 in Riverdale.
Proudly moored on the Hudson River, boasting a majestic view of the Manhattan skyline, the Binghamton is the perfect idea for your dining pleasure. Come aboard our elegantly appointed ferry and enjoy the exquisite menu of culinary delights. The Binghamton also provides beautiful banquet settings to make any affair something special. Call our banquet department for more information on planning your next function. The Binghamton's Ferry Boat Restaurant, a uniquely memorable dining experience.
If I keep selling all our cars and trucks at these low prices, Bruce says I'm fired.
He's practically giving our cars away. I can't really fire the guy. The customers love him.
Butler Chrysler Plymouth Jeep is your home for the lowest prices of all Chryslers, Plymouth Jeeps, and pre-owned cars and trucks. Prices so low, Bruce hates them. Joe might get fired for them, but you'll love them. You'll also love their state-of-the-art service, no matter where you bought your car.
Everything must go.
I want to fire him. I have to fire him. He's selling everything. I can't fire him.
Why don't you go use the woods out back?
Mike McCaskey, the owner of the Chicago Bears, who I'm sure has had more pleasant nights in his career. Watching his team being pummeled here, 41-14. Player personnel director Mark Catley. It's no fun when you're having your head handed to you. Loose ball picked up by Dwayne Rudd. Dwayne Rudd is going to go. 94 yards, touchdown.
He's going to get a 15-yard penalty for taunting.
And now we've got a fight at the other end. McDaniel was laying on top of one of the Chicago players, and some of his linemen came back to help out.
Don't let this get ugly.
Action at both ends.
Dennis is not going to like this.
Well, there are no flags down at this end on the left side.
Yeah, but there's a flag going into the end zone where Rudd really taunted the Chicago Bears chasing them. Unsportsmanlike conduct is what he's going to get.
You know, Michael, that's the third time that Chicago's been down on the goal line in that area and didn't score.
Stenstrom really, again, has trouble with Kruditz. There's the snap. Now, here goes Rudd. He just takes off right on down the field. There ain't anybody going to catch him. I mean, this is over right now. You've got a few offensive linemen trying to get down the field. Now, just before he gets in the end zone, watch what he does. He stops. He says, come on, come on. Taunting Edgar Bennett. Not a show of much class right there.
And during that whole run, Stenstrom is pinned under Ed McDaniel and another Viking during the whole run. They kept him pinned down at the 10-yard line. 48-14 back in a moment.
For it's not for everyone, only you.
Buy a Toshiba DVD player now for as low as $2.99 at Best Buy, The Good Guys, or The Wiz, and get 5 free DVD movies, plus 13 free DVD rentals from Hollywood Video or West Coast Video.
I've loved investing all of my life. It allows me to think about all the new creative things going on around me. I come across companies with great new ideas. So what do? I jump onto Schwab.com. I can get all kinds of information. I can get earnings projections. I can get what the company's done in the past. I can get their balance sheet. It allows me to have a complete, comprehensive amount of information to allow me to make a very informed decision. It's about freedom. Now you're in control.
It's ESPN Sunday Night Football. This week, Dan Marino and Vinny Testaverde square off when the Dolphins and Jets battle for a leg up in the AFC East title hunt. ESPN Sunday Night Football. Coverage begins at 8:15.
Well, I got to remember to watch that game.
48-14 Vikings. Steve Stenstrom pinned for the entire length of that run. We'll show it to you momentarily. But now after the penalties, the Vikings will be kicking off from their own 15-yard line.
We'll see how good Mitch Berger's leg is now.
Yeah, if he can put this one in the end zone, we got something.
Well, all that coaching you gave him, I'd be shocked if he doesn't get it.
He'll get it there. The Viking record, 94 yards, the longest fumble return for a touchdown. The old record set in 1962 was 88 yards by Ed Sirachman. Look at this kick. Berger puts it down to the 8 from the 15. Milburn takes it back to the 40. Kay Mays with the tackle.
All right, if you want to know what was happening on the other end of the field when Rudd is going for the touchdown, and you look at Alexander 90 and Ed McDaniel 58. Now they're on Stenson, they won't let him up. And then finally his teammates come in, and this is where the pushing and shoving went. Now remember, there were no flags down here.
I don't know why the back judge doesn't jump in and start pushing the Minnesota Vikings off instead of standing there and watching it. You know, the officials got to go in. Hey, the guys on the ground, get off them. That's where officials have to assert some power also. It's their game.
You may also be talking about a 160-pound official.
I don't care. You got a striped shirt that makes you invincible out there.
James Allen is the new running back. He's pummeled as he gets it out to the 42.
ESPN's NFL Countdown, now on Saturday at 11:30 and Sunday at 11 a.m. Eastern.
Join Chris Berman and the faculty of Bristol University for the NFL's best pregame show.
Then at 7:30, all the highlights on prime time.
Just throw him the damn ball.
And they have been. We'll see it thrown to him next week when the Jets face the Dolphins in Miami. And then in 2 weeks, we'll be back here in Minnesota as Jacksonville comes in to take on the Vikings. Stenstrom throws complete to Chris Penn. Red McCombs. Well, he picked a good time to buy in, didn't he?
You know, he tried for so long, though, Mike. You pointed that out. He tried in the 60s. He tried in the 70s down in San Antonio. The league said, get out of here. We don't want to talk to you about it. And this was the opportunity he looked for. He said, at 70, I couldn't wait much longer. They do love him up here.
And the next thing he wants is a new stadium.
Why not? Everybody else.
To replace this one. Stenstrom hangs in the pocket, throws to Conway. You know, Stenstrom was benched in favor of Moses Moreno, but every time I have seen Stenstrom play, either during the regular season or during the preseason, the guy has played well enough for his team to win if he's surrounded by better talent.
But that's the thing, Mike, is you got to be able to make plays, and you have to be able to make all the throws at the quarterback position, and Steve really can't. There are certain routes that he just can't throw. He can't throw the skinny post. He can't throw the really deep outs. It's just the way his body is made up.
Nice catch by Ingram. Stays in bounds to pick up another yard to the 23. Antonio Banks on the coverage as the Vikings using a lot of young players. For Dave Wannstedt, this has been another disappointing year. They came in with a lot of hopes. This loss will drop their record to 3-10. Dave with two more years left on his contract through the 2000 season. And the speculation is that he will be back for at least one more year, if not two. And been given it a chance to turn it around.
He's going to have to get some players.
Yes, he does. Offside that time, Terry Williams jumped early. Or Tony Williams, check it.
One of the positions they really have to address, Joe, quarterback?
Absolutely. I think they have to look for a quarterback. I mean, Eric Kramer, if he is healthy, and that's always been a big if, I think is efficient enough to be able to do a very good job for the Bears.
Wannstedt, 6 years, only 3 Pro Bowlers. Dennis Green, 12 Pro Bowlers in 7 years. That's why Dennis Green is marching toward the Super Bowl and Dave Wannstedt is marching toward another losing season. Stenson throws complete to the 8. Penn with another catch.
You know, another thing, too, when you look at Stenstrom's numbers in the second half, I mean, he had nothing in the first half when the defense just shut everything down. They didn't score a point. Now, you look at the second half, he's got 230 yards and counting. But the reason for that is that this defense is just sitting back, and they're letting him have the short stuff.
Yeah, but you watch now. You watch him tighten up a little bit now to throw on the 8-yard line. It'll be a little bit closer, it'll be a little bit tighter, and a little bit tougher to get the ball in.
First and goal. Here comes the blitz out in the flat to Ingram. And he's out of bounds at the 4.
Well, Bobby Ingram has had a great night. 8 catches, 139 yards. Isn't that bad?
Not bad at all. Here comes the route. Ingram's on the slot. They get it out to him on the sidelines. They're all over Chris Penn, and Bobby winds up going out on the 4.
But again, this is the 4th time down here. I mean, they're down here more than 4 times. But 3 times they didn't score.
Well, the big thing is get the snap from center. That's the key right now.
Quarterback draw. Stenstrom walks in. Touchdown. He ran that play very well. You know you ran that play so well yourself, you go back far enough to set it up.
The big key is you've got to sell the defense that it's going to be a pass. You have to take a few steps back, and that's what Steve does. Drops back, looks to the right, Now he allows his lineman to get out and get on the linebackers, and he walks into the end zone.
And they'll go for two.
Oh, I would.
You
would?
Yeah, if you're going to go for it on third down, you should go for two.
And for two.
Yeah,
part of
it. 48-20.
I try and work it out to Ingram again in the slot. Try and hit him on that quick slant out. Or coming the other way.
10. They've got the two-point conversion. The Chicago Bears get on the board again, but all it's going to do is change the final total, 48-22 Vikings.
It's the Maroon GM Superstore in Riverdale, where you find hundreds of new GM cars and trucks. At Maroon's GM Superstore, we'll beat any deal, whether you buy or lease any new Pontiac, Buick, or GMC truck.
Hi, I'm Ray Maroon. We'll pay off your present lease and put you on the road again with no money down.
Maroon GM Superstore, Route 23 and 287. Our service department is open nights and Saturdays. The Maroon GM Superstore at Routes 23 and 287 in Riverdale.
Sometimes doing the simple things can be difficult. No one should live with chronic pain or pain due to injury. The Pain Control Center at St. Mary's Hospital is here to help. They use many methods to treat and alleviate pain from arthritis, neck, arm, and shoulder, including whiplash injury, back pain, and more. Because no one should live with pain when help is available. The Pain Control Center at St. Mary's Hospital, 211 Pennington Avenue in Passaic.
Was your last car dealer a little over-eager to make a deal?
Come here, if I get a deal for you, let's make a deal. You can drive this baby home today.
Hey, who needs that? Discover the fun place to shop, the Bob Gisulli Auto Group.
When was the last time you had fun shopping for a car? Do you think you got the best price and payment? Did you get the most for your trade-in? Here's our special for you.
Lease the 1999 Toyota Camry for only $149 a month. Only at the Bob Gisulli Auto Group, the fun place to shop.
The world's best golfers meet down under as America defends its President's Cup title. The President's Cup begins Thursday at 4 and 8:30 on ESPN.
These overhead shots provided by the Dell Aerial Cam high above the Metrodome for ESPN Sunday Night Football, where it's 48-22 Vikings. They have won their 12th game as opposed to a single loss. And you're right, it is next. We have 2:38 to go here from the Metrodome. Only the Denver Broncos have a better record. And Jaeger is setting up for an onside kick. Loose. And it looks like the Bears have it. They do at the 40. Barry Minter helps shake it loose.
Robert Tate had a shot at it, number 83. It just bobbles around in his hand.
Greg DeLong also got his hands on it and couldn't hold it.
It goes right to DeLong, number 85, and he jumps up in the air. Look at 85 right at the bottom of your screen.
And watch right number 83. There's 83 off his helmet. That's called your hands team, by the way.
And then Minter got it.
Yeah, but it hit him in the shoulder, so that doesn't count for the hands team.
You see, he lets it get to his body. And then Tate's just trying to take it out of the air as it bounces around.
You know, it's easy for us to say, here's the guy standing DeLong, and they got eight guys running, they're going to kill him. You expect him to catch it. Stay closer.
So the Bears take over at their own 41. Nice job by Jaeger to get that high bounce. Stenstrom in the flat to Allen. Nothing doing out there. Dwayne Butler came up from his safety spot to get the first hit.
I got to believe somewhere along here, Foge is going to get a little restless just rushing four. I think at some point he's going to wind up bringing a backer, maybe bringing a safety, and they're putting a little pressure.
Second and eight. We have reached the two-minute warning at the Metrodome.
48-22, Minnesota.
Dad, where did the barn go?
Nowhere. It's there.
Are you sure?
Uh-huh. The barn will always be there.
With the right plan, you can be sure. Have you heard from the Quiet Company? Northwestern Mutual Life.
How did we get this guy to take back all those nasty things he said about electric razors? By getting in his face for 21 days. The Norelco Reflex Action for an unexpectedly close shave. Guaranteed. Norelco, put it to the test.
Weekends are for catching up with the life you miss during the week. That's why Sprint is creating a world where you can call anyone, anywhere, all weekend long. For just $25 a month. All Saturday, all Sunday. No limits. Introducing Sprint Unlimited Weekend. Come live in a world created around you. Call 1-800-PIN-DROP. Sprint. Ahead.
Clean up. Aisle 5.
We can't afford all this. Jimmy, put that towing package back. Didn't our truck come with shocks?
Not the heavy duty ones.
What size is this?
16-inch.
Need a price check on the 16-inch alloy.
Nobody wants to pay too much for options. That's why 4Runners come with a package of our most popular accessories discounted up to $900. Extra value packages available on all 4Runner models.
Hi, I'm Robert Brooks for the Green Bay Packers. The Family Violence Center provides victims and their children with safety and support. Make a difference. Support United Way.
Later on SportsCenter, we'll ask the Broncos how they survived the war against the Chiefs to stay perfect. In our Sunday conversation, we'll ask Randy Moss how would he cover himself. For Kenny Mayne, I'm Dan Patrick. We'll see you after the game.
All over but the final count. 48-22. Vikings on top of the Chicago Bears, and they have clinched the Central Division Championship, dethroning the Green Bay Packers, who had a three-year run and will now have to qualify for the playoffs as a wild card. The Vikings also clinch a first-round bye tonight. Denstrom too high for Allen. Check in with Solomon Wilcott. Solomon?
Yeah, Mike, fresh off the press, our hats and t-shirts signifying the Vikings' first division title in 4 years. Now, this merchandise will be on the shelf beginning tomorrow morning, but the way the entire town is smitten with the Minnesota Vikings, I doubt if it'll be on the shelves very long. Mike?
All right, Solomon, thank you.
Solve my Christmas presents.
Hey, Solomon. Give me half a dozen of each.
No, you're not getting those from him. He's got his first ones hot off the presses, he said.
Denstrom forced up into the pocket. Throws on the run. Hitchcock nearly had his sixth interception.
Leroy Horde has done a terrific job of filling in for Robert Smith. They hope they might have him back next week, maybe 2 weeks against Jacksonville. And I think now, you know, there's Red McCombs, the owner of the Minnesota Vikings, modeling his garb. Everybody's got the new hats on. Brad Johnson. I think the problem that Dennis is faced with now goes back a few years ago, the same situation that we saw with Mike Shanahan. Do you rest your players? You've got to buy. How long do you let them play over the next 3 weeks?
Play clock running down. The Bears will use another timeout with 1:50 to go on the clock.
Well, if he just goes back to what old Denver did,
I think they all play.
You bet.
Mike Shanahan told us last week there was no way he was going to rest his players down the stretch this time. Randy Moss with that big smile, and why not? He had another great night. Cunningham just lit up the sky with him. Three touchdown grabs for Randy Moss. He now has 14 on the season. Caught 8 balls for 106 yards. That is well under his 21.5-yard average per catch. What he's done this year, it's an NFL record. 14 touchdown catches this season. First rookie with 100 receiving yards in 3 straight games since 1960. The best rookie receiving record in Viking history. He has 9 touchdown catches over 40 yards. Only Elroy Hirsch had more than 1951. Wait till he gets some experience. Allen, nice blocks in front. Down the sideline and chased out of bounds inside the 25. A gain of 34.
Dennis Green, congratulations. Yeah, he'll smile all the time. 12-1, I'd be smiling. Throw all the water you want on me.
You know, there wasn't a lot in there. That was
no,
the
there
key.
Wasn't.
Yep. His guys drank a lot.
Was it like a courtesy?
That was just a little courtesy.
Well, Dennis is a much smaller target. He lost 60 pounds during the offseason.
Well, his goal was he'll be 50 in February, and he said his goal was to lose 50 by 50. And he's gone well past that.
Stems from under pressure, steps up again. And spun down at the 11-yard line.
Hey, Bobby Houston just pulling him down saved his life.
He made that. They can still get the first down. You see the gold ESPN and first ESPN first and 10 line at the 1. This one's out of bounds at the 10. For up-to-date score stats and analysis on all the NFL action, log on to ESPN.com. And log on to NFL.com to chat with Bronco quarterback John Elway Tuesday at 8 Eastern.
Get to ask him about that great comeback today.
Robert Smith already over 1,000 yards. Will miss this game. Maybe next week. We hope to see him in 2 weeks against the Jacksonville Jaguars in that high-powered offense. Excuse me, hopefully Mark Brunell will be all right.
You okay, partner?
Yeah.
I was lost here.
We're not going to do any Denver games this year anymore left, so don't worry.
That's choke. Choke himself, Paul.
What a tough time right now, man.
It's been a hard course there. Denstrom goes for the end zone. Penn can't get it. It's intercepted by Hitchcock. Hitchcock, who came into the weekend tied for 4th in the NFL in interceptions, gets his 6th.
Jimmy Hitchcock, number 37, and in this perfect play, we said the offense hasn't quit. Watch his defense. I mean, that's Penn coming down. Watch Hitchcock. Plays off, now turns to the ball, makes the interception, hits him right in the chest. Steve, outstanding play.
Well, Steve Stenstrup, they tried a little pump and go, but Hitchcock is just back in the end zone waiting. Chris Penn saying, hey, look, I got pushed. You're not going to get that call at this stage.
And Jay Fiedler will make an appearance at quarterback for the Vikings to run out the final 47 seconds.
This is so he can qualify for his varsity letter. He wants to get that varsity jacket. You've got to get in a certain amount of games.
Haven't been too many Dartmouth quarterbacks.
Yeah, the only bad part is he loses the yard on his first play.
The Vikings are the second team since 1970 to score 45 points in consecutive games. The 95 Raiders did it, and don't bet against them doing it again. This is an awesome offense that Dennis Green has put together. Dave wants that. It went south for him at the beginning of the ball game, and his club never able to recover. Keep an eye on that young man. He is going to set all kinds of records. We'll see him 2 weeks from now right back on this same field. Our final score, the Vikings 48, the Bears 22. Coming up next, SportsCenter. Dan Patrick and Kenny Mayne with a complete wrap-up of the day of sports. For Joe Theismann, Paul McGuire, Solomon Wilcox, and our entire ESPN crew, this is Mike Patrick. Good night from Minneapolis. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.
ESPN thanks you for watching this presentation of the National Football League.
Coming up on SportsCenter, the Broncos face their toughest test of the year. Would they pass? The BCS passes on K-State altogether. The subject of our conversation, Randy Moss, gives advice on how to cover him.
You can probably contain me, but I don't think you can stop me.
It's a red alert as the Terps have to raise it up a level against the Cardinals.
He's the elevator man!
SportsCenter, the best by leaps and bounds. Next.
Looks, he pumps, he throws it under some pressure. There's a man wide open at the 45-50, 45-40, Terry Glenn, 35-30, he's gone. New England with an 86-yard touchdown.
Pitches to Waters, running left, first down, and more. They will not get him. Ricky Waters breaks the tackle for 39 yards and a touchdown.
Elway pressure, steps up wide open, sharp, end zone, touchdown, Denver! Touchdown, Broncos, they're in the lead.
Big time production value for the same low cable price. I'm Kenny Mayne along with Dan Patrick for the SportsCenter.
Ahead on the show, more fallout on the BCS rankings. The Jets and Seahawks game comes down to a play where instant replay probably would have made a difference. But first, Denver continues its quest for perfection. The Chiefs look for a little redemption.
Or at least attempt to keep from anybody being fired or suspended. When we last visited the Broncos and the Chiefs, Derek Thomas was trying to alter the look of Shannon Sharpe's helmet, like remove the face mask. Installation of a muzzle would have been the more effective ploy. As it turns out, the silent treatment from Sharp came this week. As for the team game, not many thought Kansas City would offer much more than a whimper as the Chiefs stood to be swept by the Broncos for the first time in 7 years. Broncos trying to get out 13-0. There's much love between Shannon Sharp, Derek Thomas. It's good. First quarter, Chiefs ball, Rich Gannon, the fake, the throw, the Andre Rison touchdown. I believe that's sarcasm there. Chiefs up 7-0, still in the first. Gannon, Kimball Anders out in the flat, lowers the boom and into the end zone. 14-0 Chiefs. I love the man in the uniform. Second quarter, Broncos down 21-14. John Elway, Ed McCaffrey, he doesn't salute, but he ties the game at 21. Still 21 up, third quarter, Broncos coming, second to go. Darrell Davis has the ball, doesn't, lost it. First lost fumble in 836 touches in regular season games. The touchback for Kansas City. Chiefs following drive, Rich Gannon cranking it out for Joe Horn. Joe Horn, first career touchdown, Chiefs are up 7. The saluting thing is popular, Broncos driving. Down 31-21, 7.5 to go. Elway zips it. It's Willie Green. He beat Dale Carter. Green all the way down to the one. Actually, Dale Carter's the one who makes the play finally. Davis would score his third TD of the game. Broncos are down 3 now. Elway to Shannon Sharpe. Hadn't caught a ball all game. Did that time. And he has 7 straight 50-catch seasons. The most for tight ends. Broncos are up by 4. Here's Gannon back to throw. But Alfred Williams is laying on top of him, and he's excited as the Broncos stay undefeated. They got pushed, but nevertheless, the Broncos are just the third 13-0 team in NFL history. Denver's win clinched a first-round bye and home field advantage through the AFC playoffs. Terrell Davis now has 59 touchdowns. That breaks Marcus Allen's old record for most touchdowns in the first 4 years of a career. Here's what his coach thinks about being 13-0.
I was very proud of our football team, the way we fought back. We hung in there, didn't look for a while that things didn't look very good. We didn't take advantage of some opportunities, but I thought it showed the character of our football team, the way we hung in there and we fought for 60 minutes and found a way to win.
There were some things we did well, but the bottom line is that we couldn't stop the big plays on their offense, the chunks of yardage that they produced.
They brought it to us. They gave us everything they had. You know, they pretty much played their best game, and we didn't play our best game, but we found a way to win, and that's the ultimate goal, is to find a way to win.
Now, Elway's 400-yard passing game Sunday was the second of his career, and the fact it came this year puts him at the top of this list on the chart displaying longest time span between 400-yard games. His other came on the final regular season game back in 1985. Now the Patriots and the Steelers, children are invited to midfield to see the NFL referee's coin collection. Drew Bledsoe, broken finger two places, but didn't hurt him enough to stop him from cranking it out for Terry Glenn. 86 yards. He didn't throw it 86 yards, but the play covered that. Longest catch of Glenn's career. Patriots up 13-3. Now 16-9 Patriots. Bledsoe going for his tight end, Ben Coates. Covered by LaVon Kirkland. Good coverage, but the flag is thrown for cheating. Pass interference is called. We take another look to see how women 18-35 feel about the play. And maybe they don't feel there was interference. Kirkland hustling out there, 270 pounds. Ball at the five. And the next play, it's Robert Edwards. Weebles wobble, but they don't fall down until they get in the end zone. 23-9 the Patriots. Check it out, the immaculate implosion at Three Rivers. No one hurt. Most of the stadium is still standing. Patriots win it 23-9. Back to Glenn. He set a team record with 193 receiving yards. After losing four out of five, the Patriots have now won three straight games. This was their first win at Pittsburgh since 1986. Pittsburgh's still having a rough time on offense. The Steelers have scored just two touchdowns in their last 14 quarters.
The Jets don't have history on their side when it comes to the final month of the year. December, you see, has given New York the cold shoulder. During the 90s, the Jets have won just six games total in December. But linebacker Pepper Johnson wasn't in the mood for a history lesson while prepping for the Seahawks this week. The only thing I want to hear about Jets history, said Johnson, is Super Bowl III. Phil Luckett and his crew don't want to hear any more about the coin flip controversy on Thanksgiving Day. 7-0 Jets first quarter. John Kitna changes all of that. Finds Joey Galloway. 70 yards as he burns Aaron Glenn. Tied at seven. But don't tell anybody about it. Next Seahawk possession. It's a different angle. It's the same result. It's Galloway getting behind Glenn again. 14-7 Seahawks. 21-13 Seahawks. Third quarter, Vinny Testaverde under pressure. Picked off by the rookie out of Clemson, Anthony Simmons. And he will avoid Testaverde's weak attempt. NFL best 10th touchdown by Seattle's defense or special teams, 28-13. Jets down 31-19. Testaverde looking for Keyshawn Johnson, having a Pro Bowl year. Testaverde completed 42 passes, but the Jets trailed by five. Fourth quarter, 4th and 9. Rather than go for John Hall field goal, Testaverde hits Dedrick Moore on the slant. Jay Bellamy drills him short of the first down with Bill Parcells' decision haunting. The officials huddle before the Jets' last drive saying, let's don't screw it up. 4th and goal from the 5, 27 seconds to go. Testaverde convinces Bill Parcells the quarterback sneak. Now, there's no signal from the referees initially. 18 seconds after Testaverde goes down, the refs finally signal a touchdown, and Dennis Erickson has got to be miffed. Parcells says, guys, I want a two-point conversion. Stop celebrating. Look at it again. Another bad call. Knee goes down, doesn't break the plane. Another brutal day for Luckett's crew as the Jets pick up the victory by the final of 32-31. The win, the Jets' sixth straight at home, keeping them atop of the AFC East. Aaron Glenn, the Pro Bowl defensive back, suffered a sprained ankle. Reserve fullback Keith Byers broke his arm. The status of these two players will be further evaluated on Monday. Testaverde throwing a career-high 63 passes, completing 42 for 418 yards and two touchdowns. Following the game, you didn't have to read between the lines to get Dennis Erickson's take on Testaverde's sneak.
Most disappointing loss I've ever been involved in. I mean, you play like we did, and it gets down to that one play, and just totally disappointing.
I just don't think they stepped up to the plate and did an accurate job of officiating the game at the end when it was on the line. You know, anybody can officiate it when it's the easy calls. But, I mean, I need you there. You're trained for crunch time. And I don't think they follow through with that.
I didn't see the damn play, okay? Okay? You're telling me what the hell I'm looking at.
John Gruden's offense struggled in the first half against the Dolphins' defense. First quarter after an Oakland blocked punt. Donald Hollis to Ricky Dudley. Off Dudley, Sam Madison, and INT. Dolphins would get a field goal in the ensuing possession. Robert Jones introduces himself to Donald Hollis at the 2-yard line. Next play, Hollis. Looking for Harvey Williams. This looks like Joe Theismann to Jack Squirek. 10-0 Dolphins. Second quarter, Raiders down 17-0. Sam Madison says hello to Hollis. Raiders got a field goal on the drive. Oakland's next possession. It's Donald Hollis looking for Harvey Williams. I think it's a good idea to stay away from Harvey Williams. Robert Jones takes it back. Hollis, 6 interceptions, sacked 8 times. Raiders lose by the final of 27-17. So after turning four first-half turnovers into 24 points, the Dolphins held on to remain tied with the Jets atop the East. Miami created six turnovers, raising its league-leading total to 26. The Dolphins also added eight sacks. To Cincinnati, the Bengals and the Bills. Bills owner Ralph Wilson vowing to be on his best behavior. Those 80-year-olds can get out of hand. Doug Flutie to Eric Moulds. Oh, does Doug Flutie have a weapon? Set up an Antoine Smith touchdown. Bills up 7-0. Bengals down 10-6. Lee Johnson can't hold on to the snap. Doug Pelfrey can't pick up the loose ball. And if you're a Bengal fan, would that be paper or plastic? Less than 2 minutes to go in the first half. Bills down 13-10. Flutie, Moulds, goodbye. They're not gonna get him. Moulds, a career day. More on that in a moment. Fourth quarter, Bills up 26-13. Flutie under pressure.
Flutie under pressure.
Guess who he goes to? Eric Moulds. Oh, yeah. Isn't that great to be a Cincinnati fan and then they want a new stadium? Boy, that's a great product. Do I sound bitter? Do I sound like I'm from Cincinnati originally? 33-20, the final. The Bills have won 8 of their last 10 to stay in the chase in the East. Moulds turned in the fifth best receiving game in team history. 6 catches, 196, 2 scores. The Bengals, who have lost 8 straight, figure to have lost Neil O'Donnell for the rest of the season. He's got a broken hand.
If computers are really all they're cracked up to be, why didn't the ones from Jeff Sagarin and the New York and Seattle Times kick in with some artificial intelligence and spit out the decision that the final BCS declaration is that there be a playoff? Instead, losses on Saturday by the former unbeaten Kansas State and UCLA required some rethinking on everyone's part about which two are the top two and deserve a spot in the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl. In the end, the two major polls and the 1-2 ranking of the BCS computation match up. It's unbeaten Tennessee, which got by Mississippi State on Saturday, and once beaten Florida State. Those two will play for the national title January 4th. Here are the shiny, happy people involved.
Our team has been very resilient all year long and found a way to get it done at the end. Obviously, this is a very exciting time for our program. We've been right on the edge and right in the mix to be have a chance to be in this national championship game, and now we're getting a chance to do it.
Well, I've watched Tennessee through the year, and they definitely deserve to be where they are. I mean, they started from day one, and they have the symptoms of a national championship team. I just hope we can play good against them.
Florida State has better holiday decorations. Here now, your runner-up BCS bowl games. UCLA will play in the Rose against Wisconsin. Ohio State gets Texas A&M in the Sugar. Florida and Syracuse will contest the Orange. Kansas State ended up third in the BCS rankings, but didn't land a BCS bowl game. K-State will be remembered for playing in the Alamo against Purdue.
Still to come in the program, with the Terrapins' highest ranking in 22 years be short-lived. We have the highlights of the number 2 Terps and the number 5 Cardinal, not to mention the rest of the day and night from the NFL.
Looking on his feet, Chandler receiving the football.
Fred Taylor running left magazine. He's at the 10. He's at the 5. He's into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville.
They'll run it. Terry Kirby trying to sweep the right side. Stopped. He wants to throw to Owens in the end zone. Touchdown, right corner. Oh, they buffaloed the Panthers on that one.
Spider-Man got sick, so I don't have to be the dumb dinosaur. I get to be the peacock.
Great. Peacock.
Want to get away? Southwest has your ticket to freedom. For only $99 or less, you can fly coast to coast when you purchase by December 16th.
You are now free to move about the country.
With an extra value package, the 99 Corolla CE comes with power windows, power door locks, and air conditioning. So you and your friends will be a lot more comfortable.
Hey, we can fit 2 more in here. Come on!
Every year during the holidays, great to be here in the Rocky Mountains. And not just because it's so darn pretty either. This is a great place to be because it's home. sure hope you can be home for the holidays, too.
When we were traveling cross-country, we stopped at a place. They had the business channel. We started watching, and the market was going down, and we said, there are these stocks we wanted to buy, and from the road, we called up.
Called Schwab because we didn't have a phone modem in the motorhome, so we couldn't trade online. Where were we?
Utah.
We're
in Utah.
On a payphone, talking to Schwab, buying the stocks. There's a feeling of exhilaration. Hey, we've done it. You've committed to it. Then we got back in the motorhome, traveled on our way.
And those purchases have done
very well.
SportsCenter is brought to you by Charles Schwab, providing people, technology, and support to help you gain financial control. And by Southwest Airlines, proud sponsor of the NFL and official airline of the Super Bowl.
Well, it certainly looks like the Vikings have started wrapping their Christmas presents a little early this season. On Sunday night, Minnesota looked to put a bow on the Central Division with a win over the Bears. A victory would not only give the once-beaten Vikes their first title since 1994, it would also secure a first-round bye. Randy Moss, a big reason for the Vikings' success. Bears plan to double-team him all night. How about a third guy? First play from scrimmage, Randall Cunningham to Mo Williams, in for the injured Robert Smith, and he's gone for 64 yards. Williams' first touch of the season. Two plays later, from the Bears' six, Cunningham, Moss, 12th touchdown on the year. Meanwhile, Chris Carter, the other half of the Vikings' dynamic duo, out with a calf strain. He would not catch a pass, first time in 111 games that had happened. That meant more catches for Moss. Eight catches, this one in front of Walt Harris, 27-0 Vikings. Third quarter, the coup de grace.
Cunningham with a
27-7 Vikings, Cunningham, Moss. Moss, first rookie to make 14 touchdown receptions in his first 13 games. There's plenty more where that came from. Vikings win this one easily to clinch the division. 44-22 the final, 48-22 the final in this one. Vikings break the Packers' three-year hold on the Central, clinching the first round bye. Minnesota joins the 95 Raiders as the only teams since the merger to score 45 points in back-to-back games within a season. Next Sunday night, it will be the Jets. It will be Miami. It will be the game before the game for the Dolphins, because they've got the Denver Broncos, who could come into Miami perfect. The Dolphins and the Jets next Sunday night with Mike Patrick, Joe Theismann, and Paul McGuire, 8:15 Eastern. To Jacksonville, Jaguars, Lions, first quarter, second play of the game. Mark Brunell, his final play of the game, hit by Robert Porchet. Brunell's left leg gets caught, and he sprained it.
He is slow to get up.
Did not return. Backup quarterback Jamie Martin took over. First quarter, no score. Oh, did he ever take over? Keenan McCardell with a touchdown. 7-0 Jaguars. And McCardell, knowing that there's no NBA highlights, does his best George Mikan impersonation. Second quarter, Lions down 17-3. First and 10 from the 41-yard line. Barry Sanders, great cutback. 39 yards down to the Jaguars, too. Detroit would kick a field goal. It was 17-6. Still 17-6. Martin, Jimmy Smith, 24-6. Jaguars. Early in the fourth quarter, 27-16, Fred Taylor. Fred Taylor, 183 yards. The touchdown, Jaguars win it by the final of 37-22. The win allowed the Jaguars to move three games up on the Steelers in the Central. Taylor earned $350,000 in bonuses for going over 1,000 yards and scoring 12 touchdowns. Sanders went over 100 yards for the first time in three games, but failed to score a touchdown rushing for the seventh consecutive game.
The 49ers carried on Sunday after the loss of Bryant Young. The Panthers carried on after the loss of 10 games. San Francisco sought a sweep of Carolina for the second straight season. Obtaining it was a near necessity if the Niners were to keep pressure on Atlanta for the NFC West lead. Third quarter, Niners are rolling up 21-7. Garrison Hurst, the handoff, and he's going places. Watch Terrell Owens come along, knock out Brent Alexander, the good late block, and Hurst scoots in at 28-7. Now 28-14 in the fourth. Steve Berline leading a comeback here. Lobs it up, Rocket Ismail had to steady for the ball. Has to reach over for the goal, 40 yards and in, it's 28-21. After a Niners punt, Tim Biakabatuka, 10 yards and in, great scrabble score, ties the game at 28. Now 27 seconds left, tied at 28. John Casey, chance to win it for Carolina.
Newbie!
And he pulls it right. Not good from 47. Still 28. We'll go to overtime. First possession, Berline. Military precision. Chris Dolman right to him. He recovers it. 49ers ball. And Steve Young rolling, keeping. Goes 21. Slides in at the 10. He's fast. Sets up Wade Ritchie. 23 and good. And the Niners win this thing 31-28. Niners ended up with 236 rushing yards in this one. That's the most ever given up by Carolina. San Francisco's now won at least 10 games in 16 straight seasons. That extends its NFL record. This win clinched a playoff berth. Carolina dropped to 1-8 this season in games decided by 7 points or less. The Colts, the Falcons. Colts are up 14-0, and the Falcons get fancy. Chris Chandler to Jamal Anderson. Back to Chandler, launches it out for Tony Martin. That's a restaurant-quality play, 40-yard play, 14-7, the Falcons are down. Minute left in the first half, third and one for the Colts. Travis Hall reading it, lost his helmet, kept his mouthpiece. A variation of the chicken dance, Falcons driving, 5 seconds left in the half. Chris Chandler, nobody open, but there's space in front of him. Then he tries to show how strong his arm is and throw the ball through the stadium. Chandler, 3-yard touchdown, tied at 21. Peyton Manning, first play of the second half, share, and he does. Ray Buchanan, the former Colt, picking him off, takes it back inside the 15. 3 plays later, we counted. Chandler. I said Chandler. This time he'll have a man. The fake, the roll, Terrence Mathis. Good throw, and Ray Buchanan likes what he set up over on the sidelines. 28-21, the Falcons. Still same score, 28-21, and Jamal Anderson. Blowing by and through people, 26 yards, 30 carries, a buck 22. Falcons are winners. Falcons are 11-0 when he has 20 or more carries, and they do well when his mother's shown also. That's 6 in a row for Atlanta, and the Falcons hold their one-game lead in the NFC West. Chandler ended up 20 of 28, touchdown run and 2 touchdown throws. His counterpart, Peyton Manning, we just showed him getting picked, but he actually broke Rick Meyer's rookie record for passing yards in a season with 3 games still to play. He also holds the rookie record of throwing a touchdown in 10 straight games.
They are 8-0. They are ranked second in the country, and they are winning by an average of 32 points a night. Those gaudy numbers perhaps conjure up images of a cream puff schedule, but the Maryland Terrapins have proven they can treat quality opponents like UCLA and Pittsburgh, just like they did Hofstra and Western Carolina. On Sunday, Maryland needed to raise its game and perhaps lower its expectations when the fifth-ranked Cardinal came calling at the MCI Center. Steve Francis gets the ball from Terrence Morris eventually. Maryland up by 7 at halftime. Second half, more Francis. He's only 6'3". Yeah, right. Maryland up 5. Stanford would stage a comeback. Peter Sauer, the pull-up for 3 that touches portion of the rim and then the bottom of the net. We're tied at 45. Stanford would eventually go up by 3. Steve Francis in the spot shadow. Gets out of the spot shadow. Makes the steal. And then takes it the distance. Part of an 8-0 run. Mike Montgomery needs a timeout. Stanford down 3 with 16 to go. Sauer can't hang on to it. Montgomery telling the team to get back. They don't. Ron Proffitt at the other end. Maryland wins it 62-60. Steve Francis, the man, the go-to guy, came from Allegheny Community College. The junior college transfer scored 24, 9 more than his average. You don't have to be perfect in the final 5 minutes of a game, said Coach Gary Williams. You just have to play tough and smart. In Tennessee, the Vols in Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh, which came in averaging 78 points, was held to just 53. The Vols held the Panthers to a 31% shooting performance. Tennessee attempted 24 more free throws than Pittsburgh did.
Please stay. More football's coming. The Cowboys would clinch a playoff spot with the win in New Orleans. This year didn't help. And our college guys will analyze the final numbers, the ones that show Kansas State rated third, but not in a BCS bowl.
The more challenging the path, the more rewarding the life. That's the real spirit of a man. The Johnny Walker Collection, sportswear and accessories.
We
got everything on everyone's wish list.
What are you doing?
That TV is for your parents. What? That VCR is for our nephews. Will you stop it? That mini system is for your brother. These are gifts.
Not till December 25th, they're not.
We've got all the games on your Wiz list. Sony PlayStation, Nintendo 64, now $129 each, only at the Wiz.
I say we keep everything.
Cool.
What's on your Wiz list?
History. The top rushers in college football history have all won the Heisman. Archie Griffin. Herschel Walker. Charles White. Tony Dorsett. Now, one man has passed them all. Will Ricky Williams take his place in Heisman history? Or will one of these playmakers beat him to the podium? The Heisman Trophy Award Presentation Show, Saturday at 7:30, only on ESPN.
Back with more Tackle Football, the Cowboys, the Saints, 9-3 Saints. Kerry Collins, a little pressure, sidesteps that, and lays it out for Andre Hastings. Beat everyone. Outruns Kevin Mathis, 89 and in. Collins' second touchdown pass of the first half, and new form of celebration for the Saints. They're so cute at that age. Next week, they'll hang a pinata from the goalpost. Rough for Emmett Smith in this game. People leapfrogging to get to him. Joe Johnson coming through. Zips him for a 9-yard loss. 22-3 Saints in garbage time. Emmett trying to get in for his 124th career rushing touchdown. It would be a record, but he's dropped there, and then he's stuffed again. Mike Ditka said it's the best D he's seen, and Dallas coach Chan Gailey said, we got the dog beat out of us. The Saints held Emmett Smith to 6 yards, held the Cowboys to 8 rushing yards total, kept Dallas out of the end zone, and more importantly, kept the Cowboys from getting into the playoffs. A Dallas win would have clinched a spot. Saints quarterback Kerry Collins is now 3-0 playing against Dallas. The Ravens and Oilers, 3-zip, the Oilers, Eddie George. He's alone in the backfield. And now he's alone in the end zone. 10-0 the Oilers. 20 seconds left in the first half, and this is festive. Brad Hopkins flipping up Michael McCrary. Some shoving, pushing, 15-yard penalty on Hopkins. Fourth quarter, less than 2 minutes left. Jim Harbaugh trying to get back in it. He does. Zips it to Floyd Turner, second touchdown of the game. Ravens down 16-14. Now 55 seconds to go. The Ravens coming. Harbaugh deep. Deflected by Samari Roll. And Steve Jackson comes up with the pick. Nice play on the D. The Oilers hang on to win it 16-14. So Tennessee still has playoff considerations by avoiding a third straight loss. The Oilers haven't made the playoffs since the 1993-94 season. Tennessee entered the game with the fewest sacks in the NFL. Came up with a season-high 6 on Sunday. The Oilers also got 3 field goals from Al Del Greco, 2 of them from 48 yards out.
For weeks, the football rankings appeared to be comprised of more BS than BCS. 3 unbeatens, 2 positions, 1 bowl game. But after the fallout of Saturday's action, the cry in college football is no longer who's number one, but rather who's number two. As we told you earlier in SportsCenter, Florida State is the beneficiary of the losses turned in by UCLA and Kansas State, and as a result, the Seminoles will face top-ranked Tennessee for the national title. Now that's the abridged version of the BCS rankings. Here to explore more, our college team quarterback, Mike Chris Fowler. Chris.
Hi, we're joined by the Cirrus Trophy. That's the prize that goes to the champion in the coach's poll that'll be awarded on the field in Tempe January 4th to the winner of the Tennessee-Florida State game. The Seminoles, as in 93, need help late in the season.